We got Nintendo DS's tool for sexual predators.
What?
Yeah, we should play this. We just
tool.
Oh, we just ended with the news teases, so this is like kind of an extension of that. Yeah,
Nintendo DS. Okay, it's that portable.
Kids can't put it down.
It has lots of graphics.
And who can blame them?
It's extremely fun.
The thing's a blast.
Oh, dude, awesome.
But what makes Nintendo DS different from other handheld game devices...
It's got dual screens, so hence the name Nintendo DS Dual
Screen. Babies.
That's right, two screens. You can play Game Boy and Nintendo DS games on it. And what's even more, friends like Marissa and Melanie can play against each other, even if they're in different cars.
We were several car lengths apart, and sure enough, they were playing the game together.
That's because the Nintendo DS units seek out other DS units to play with. Well, stop the music. Because it's also redefining how vulnerable your kids are to child molesters.
Whoa.
Why?
We were just having fun.
What happened?
The music was nice. We were driving. We were playing. And then all of a sudden, I got a dick in my ass. What happened?
You know what? That's how it happens.
That's right.
Yeah, that's the new, hey, kid, you want some candy?
Right.
The new thing is you play video games. This is the greatest game ever.
Ow! My ass! What the fuck?
That's what it all ends up. All ends up with a dick in your ass.
With a dick in your ass. You're playing games. You're having fun. I'll never get that Nintendo game.
Yeah.
No. Stick to PSP. Or computer gaming.
PSP. Great games and no anal rape.
Right. That's how they should present it.
They just have a picture of a dick going into an ass with the line through it.
Yeah, the red circle and line through it. That'd sell with the parents.
You see, along with the game capability, Nintendo DS comes with a feature called PictoChat.
You can chat with your friends.
Kids know what it is.
You can talk to other people from a long distance.
I've PictoChatted with my neighbor.
Problem is, parents don't.
You know, I don't see that piece advertised on commercials.
No.
Let me explain. You open the DS unit, you turn it on, you push PictoChat, and your DS unit is an open book. Anyone can write your child messages, send them sketches, anyone who has a DS unit. It's that simple.
The fact that someone could possibly communicate with him without me knowing hadn't crossed my mind.
Let me explain. You turn it on, you send a message, dick in his ass. That's how it works.
And that's it. People just will send your kid horrible messages. What are the... I'm not exactly positive on the capabilities of this little device. I'm a PSP guy. I know how that works. I know I could get on my wireless network at home with it. Are they talking about a Wi-Fi? Or are they talking about system-to-system communication? Like, can you get on some type of online server with that? Or can the systems just talk to each other if you're close enough?
No, it all matters that if you're close enough.
Okay.
So if you're close enough and a sexual predator has
so
one
you
of
need
these.
To be near a sexual predator right. that has a Nintendo DS.
Right.
He can't be 100 miles away on his computer or 100 miles away on a DS.
How close does a sexual predator have to be if you're playing that right now?
Personally, I've checked this PictoChat. I've never seen anyone in chat room A
on it.
Through D.
Get on PictoChat.
Oh, you've never seen anyone in the actual chat room.
It shows 0 through 16.
Yeah, you're Mr. Sexual Predator just waiting and waiting.
One guy in there.
To yourself.
And then all of a sudden, two guys. It's like, hi, how old are you? I'm 40. I'm waiting, too. Get your own fucking room.
Hey, it's sort of like when you first become a sexual predator. You don't know how to go about it. Like, well, maybe I'll try
newbie.
This isn't working out.
Listen, noob.
And you meet, like, the headlining pedophile. You got to go to the playgrounds.
Dude, you don't even know where to go.
Yeah, man. Start with the playground.
You're walking around fucking Wall Street with your
head. Use your head. Go to the zoo, for Christ's sake.
Go to where the kids are, you idiots.
Library. Everyone knows.
Join the circus. Dress like a clown. Do I got to spell it out for you?
So fucking easy.
Kitty party. Mom's too busy getting the cake ready in the kitchen. And
look for houses.
Yeah, free reign with the kid in the backyard.
Balloons in the backyard and a party going on because they'll probably be given this as a gift or some of the kids will have it. And you can get on the PictoChat. And what I like to do is draw pictures of my cock and send them over. people, the kids write back and say, what's this? Because I'm not a very good artist. And he can't send pictures.
Well, I make it look like a giraffe at first, just to get him hooked.
He just drew a tick on the picture chat.
There you go. Send it. Please send that and get
arrested. There's no one in the room.
I send it to myself.
For the love of God, get a unicycle. It's the pedophile's Corvette. It is a kid magnet.
Right.
Kids are fascinated by him.
You want to go for a ride? There's only one seat. Hop on.
Pedophile's Corvette. Holy shit. Let me see that little gizmo. Now,
you've drawn three dicks. Now, you're in a room.
Right now, I'm in a chat room.
If somebody
had a DS, they could join this chat room.
And you can then send this.
Right, I could send technically anything.
That looks like a makeup case.
Yeah, it really does, right?
This is the lamest fucking thing. Awful.
You know, I had one of those.
That should be one of those little powder things comes out of it.
No, I
makeup!
I got money for it.
I
got a game for it. I hated that stupid thing. Nintendo DS.
I'm going to write, fuck you, and then send.
There you go. Yes.
I don't know. If someone's in the room, they can see it. No one's in the room. Hello? Hello? And there's a little signal thing up here, but like you said, are you sure? This can't even go over the fucking internet.
No, you can't go on the internet.
That's Nintendo's PSP?
Yeah.
Thank you. This is just not a video gamer.
Neither are people that buy that.
We got more to the story here. More to the story.
Here's an example of what can happen. With Melanie and Marissa upstairs in the bedroom, I was downstairs sending them messages. What's your dog's name? What's your name? Where do you go to school?
I'm in your house.
Marissa's.
How about that fucking one?
Yeah.
I'm in your fucking house. Hi. The pedophile has to get in your house first. After that, I don't care if he's fucking doing the dishes. I want him out.
School. Where do you live? Marissa's mom was watching as Melanie and Marissa answered my questions, and she didn't like what she saw.
Especially when I saw Melanie write in the address.
What's 2, 4, 5?
Granted, the girls knew it was me sending the messages,
but
they'd only
met me
minutes before.
Damn. If that wasn't advertising for sexual predators, there's an easy one at 2, 4, 5.
If you're a pedophile, become a newsman. You'll gain access to young children, their houses, and the trust of their mother.
You'll get a microphone and people will trust you.
And I could send pornographic messages to young children right in their house in front of their mother. What a gig.
Under the disguise of doing a news story.
I went upstairs and removed the clothing from the children.
What the fuck is this guy doing? He's in the house. How dangerous could that be? This is a needle in a haystack situation.
Well, here's another ridiculous scenario.
And remember Marissa chatting with her friend in the other car?
Yeah, watching her on
Paltalk. That means a molester driving along to see your child in the back seat and start sending messages while you're in the front seat, totally oblivious to what's happening.
Will you stop scaring parents out there?
Pedophile.
Pedophile sees your kid with a DS and starts following the car and starts chatting.
Following the car. So he's got to drive and follow, or does he get a friend that knows he's a pedophile?
Yeah, and wouldn't your kid have to be driving the car to actually truly be in danger? I mean, you're there.
Right. You're there.
All right.
What's he going to drive chatting. By with his dick out the window? Maybe get a little jizz on the side of your fucking...
Here's a little car fat toy.
I couldn't go with Pinto again. I always say Pinto.
Here's a little factoid.
Okay.
On the system, the range, 30 to 100 feet.
Oh,
so I guess 100 feet under optimum conditions. 30 feet. Your child has to be within 30 feet or 100 feet at most of a predator that has a DS.
I'm actually going to say that story is absolutely shameless. There's no way adults can sit there in a room and not know that that's complete horseshit.
It's going,
And what about all the sexual predators out there? They just got another idea.
They're not going to do it. Even they know. They don't want to get caught. That is a cry for help. You need to catch me if you actually use
this is a
fucking...
I'm 30 feet away from you.
This is how hack. The fuck?
Yeah, this is hack
when it comes to sexual predators.
Come on.
In the back seat and start sending messages while you're in the front seat, totally oblivious to what's happening. Nintendo is well aware of the risk. Both the owner's manual and the company's website warn parents about PictoChat and recommend talking to your kids about what to do if they get a message from someone they don't know. Brenda and Chantel are both great moms, but like most parents, they didn't think to read the owner's manual for their child's game.
I hadn't thought about that.
I just thought it was kind of like an advanced Game Boy.
Sit down, read the manual, the instructions.
Joel Dine with Glendale Police says the problem is parents don't realize Nintendo DS is more than just a game device.
It's a communication tool. It's not just a visual tool. So
now, text, Michael, walkie, Marissa, talkie, and Melanie know exactly what to do if a stranger tries to PictoChat them.
I sign off. I say bye.
I'll turn it off.
What was the question? What'd you do if you saw a cock on there, kid?
Yeah, how do they ask him?
Yeah, how do you know?
You
ever
think about anything graphic?
What do you say? What would you do if something was written on there that from a stranger? Well, what do you mean? What if it's another kid? Okay,
well,
stranger
no kid.
That has hair around his genitals.
Ew! Just answer the question. We need a soundbite. Answer slowly and lick your lips.
Let me show you what he might draw.
He might draw one of the following.
These.
Right. Hey, mommy.
Just as I suspected, it is scary for the child. Ma'am, relax. We're just acting. This is
the
just
news.
Role-playing.
The news.
It's okay. I'm a newsman.
I'm a newsman. I'm allowed to do anything to your children because I'm a news guy.
What a dumb, worthless, nothing story. There is no danger there. I defy you to find one child that has had one inappropriate message sent by a stranger.
You know what? I bet are a lot of pedophiles in journalists.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get to wear like the raincoat anyway, so it's like a good disguise.
Put that trench coat around and just, yeah.
A good Clark Kent.
Okay. What would a child say if I opened my trench coat and was naked? Let's try and find out.
Worst death ever.
Yes.
Jimmy?
A Long Island landscaper was crushed to death yesterday by a commercial lawnmower.
Well, that doesn't sound that bad or out of the ordinary. Probably taking it off the truck with another landscaper. It could crush him.
I've seen a lot of those landscapers. Those commercial mowers weigh maybe 100 pounds.
That's it. I mean, and if it hits you right on the head, it's probably pretty instantaneous. So I don't see how that's the worst death. You're a liar, Jim.
Yeah, why is it worst death ever?
Well, this is how you know that this your life is godless. Crushed to death by a lawnmower that toppled on him as he fell into a cesspool.
Okay.
I don't mean to laugh.
Now.
We're hurt on Long Island.
Now you're getting horrible.
He was in the back in Colmac, and when his mower suddenly plunged into a grass-obscured cesspool filled with about 3 feet of sewage, he
Jesus.
Died.
Sewage is the polite way of saying.
Of course. Human waste. He died. Pinned to a wall of human waste by his own lawnmower.
By his own lawnmower that fell through a hole that... What was Bugs Bunny put the little blanket of grass over a hole? What the hell? Why was a cesspool just covered with a little grass?
I don't know.
You would think they would warn the landscaper.
Yeah.
You might want to stay away from that area over there.
Maybe stake it off.
Or was it a sinkhole that appeared?
No, they said it was a cesspool. Fell into a cesspool and was crushed. How awful is that?
Pinned down by your mower while you drown in human waste.
You know, your face and your teeth probably scraped the wall as you were falling in.
Oh, God. Oh, that's horrible. I gotta say, that is a horrible, horrible way to go.
There's never been a worse way to go than being crushed by a lawnmower. Because it's a nice day out yesterday.
Yeah.
Cutting the grass. Probably sing a tune.
Cutting the grass.
I don't know if that's worst death ever.
Worst death ever.
I'm going to challenge
that. Yeah, that's pretty bad. What could be worse than being in human feces and being crushed at the same time?
Well, you have to tell other people in heaven. You have to see your relatives. Oh.
What about the guy? I'm going to have to get the story, but his arm got caught in like a chocolate-making machine.
That's fun.
Ooh.
And then his whole body was dragged into the machine, and he died in a vat of chocolate.
That's a yummy death.
That's yummy.
Well, death is yummy.
Kind of like the cesspool guy, color-wise.
Yeah. They both look the same, but I don't know. I don't know. I think chocolate doesn't make it as bad as human waste is what it is.
Well,
chocolate's fun.
We challenge Jimmy today. Worst death ever. We'll see what the listeners come up with, okay? Boston, you can't contribute to this because I think the show just started for you, so I'm sorry.
Oh, right, with the delay. Yeah, although they do have a doozy.
Huh?
Although they do have a doozy.
What do you mean?
You're just driving to work and a giant steel plate falls on your car and crushes you.
Yeah, that's worst death ever.
That's a pretty bad one, but...
Quick. Huh? That's quick. We get the manhole covers here in New York that just pop up and crush it every once in a while. Yeah. Or you walk your dog, you get electrocuted because he takes a leak on a pole that's not wired
properly. That's a bad one.
Or we had one, you know, those grates. Someone's walking over a grate, fell 25 feet to their death.
Oof. I don't walk on them.
Huh?
Sometimes you're forced to, though.
My mother fell through one when she was very young.
No, she wasn't.
She told me how she did when she was a little girl. She fell through a wooden one.
No, she wasn't. Didn't.
You think?
Did she really? How far did she fall?
I don't know. She didn't die.
Let's go to Pittsburgh. It's been a while. Josh, what's going on, man?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, you guys are talking about accents and stuff, you know, in different parts of the country. Hey, Pittsburgh, we got a pretty bad accent down here. We get made fun of all the time, you know. We say yens and stuff like that a lot, so.
Pittsburgh has kind of like a southern Chicago thing going on.
Yeah, it's close.
Yeah, we're pretty bad. I've been all over the country, and everybody knows when you're from Pittsburgh.
Knows. That's like a Maryland thing, too. No.
Well, I mean, Baltimore. Baltimore accent.
Baltimore row.
Accident. Baltimore accent.
Sal says my brother's name. Hey, Joseph. Brother's name is Joseph. Joseph. Hey, Joseph, where's Roe? Yeah. We're going to the boat. What the hell is that?
Joseph.
Joseph, where's Joseph? How do you spell that? Love Sal.
Yeah, thanks a lot, man. I love you guys down here. We all love you guys.
Bye.
Well, not all of you in Pittsburgh. Why don't you tell a friend? Why don't you do us a favor and tell a friend or two, all right?
Help us out here. Come on, Henry. Trying to keep this job, Henry.
All right, Josh. Yeah, we want to continue broadcasting to Pittsburgh, so thank you, sir. Girl loses feet at Six Flags. At this point, man, summer's here. I'm too scared to go to the amusement parks.
There are so many reasons I don't go.
And I'm not scared of rides, but I just don't... I don't have any faith in the people that run them.
How about the gang members cutting the lines?
Exactly. That is the biggest thing going on at Six Flags Great Adventure in Jersey. Oh, man. You go there, it is just unbelievable. You will be standing there, and a gang members will cut you in line, and don't you dare say a word, or you will just be pummeled. And that makes a great... amusement park going experience. But, if you make it onto the rides, then you got to worry about a malfunction or something. If you're going to be dangling upside down on a loop coaster for a half hour or have your legs chopped off.
Yeah, amusement park mishaps growing, question mark? Well, I don't know. Who knows? I mean, the media likes to blow everything out of proportion. So.
They're probably very safe. For the most part, I think there's more amusement parks being built and more wild rides being built, so you can get more people thrown off of these things or killed in certain ways.
I don't know if it's growing. I think it's always been there, but the media just reports on it more or something. Because
the old days, they were just plain dangerous. You ever see some of the footage of the old Coney Island rides? They had those little discs that spun around, and you went down a slide, and the spinning disc would throw you onto another spinning disc, and it just looked like your fingers could be chopped off in the mechanism.
That would be good to do a little research on some of the old rides that they just said, we got to ban them. Yeah,
too dangerous.
We're not cavemen anymore. We got to ban these rides.
Just awful, dangerous things. But apparently some people, I think it was Six Flags in Kentucky. Was it Kentucky?
Mm-hmm.
Kentucky. It was this Superman-type ride. Not the Superman roller coaster from Jersey, but it's like one of those big towers. And it has this, gondola on it, and it rides up the tower. It's one of those things that almost look like where you get kind of a nice view.
Yeah.
It's not even a ride. You just get in, and this...
Oh, this thing doesn't
thing
drop right
goes up the tower. It looked like that. But when it gets to the top, it drops.
That's what I mean.
And
okay.
You reach speeds of over 50 miles an hour as it drops down.
Oh, I thought you were like, you get the nice view, and then they just give a nice little spin.
A little spin, and it goes down.
And then
down.
Slowly come back down.
Well, that's what it looks like. But
it's one of these things where it does drop.
Yeah, you go up.
Free fall.
And then it drops you down. And a cable snapped, and the thing plummeted to the ground, and I'm not sure if it was the cable snapping or the impact of the ground, but I think her legs were severed.
Well, an amusement park ride is now shut down after a horrible accident in Kentucky. The teen girl's legs were severed when a free-fall ride malfunctioned at a Six Flags park in Louisville. The girl was on the Superman Tower of Power. It pulls riders up 177 feet before dropping them at speeds of 50 miles an hour. Witnesses say they heard a cable snap and the ride hit the ground.
The lady, she was just sitting there, and she didn't have no legs.
We've got season passes. Now my kids are having, you know, we're not coming back for sure.
Six Flags has not said exactly what went wrong, but is investigating the incident, and we still don't know how the injured girl is doing.
A Superman ride that removes your ability to walk.
Wow.
It sounds like a perfect ride to me.
I didn't even think of that.
You get on the horse, it throws you off, and they refund your season pass money.
Oh, God.
Guy's all pissed. We'll never come back here again. Duh.
What happened to her feet?
I don't know. They're gone.
Where did someone have to go? Did someone say, go get those feet quickly?
Go get her feet. It might be the cable. When that snapped under pressure, under tension like that, it could have just whoosh, and cut your legs right off.
Oh, Danny's got an update.
From Danny.
What do you got, Danny?
Yeah, I was watching a different version of that story, and the cable that had snapped, I don't know exactly how you're situated in the ride, but I think your legs kind of like hang over, kind of like the Batman ride.
Ah, okay.
So the cable snapped because one of the witnesses said they saw the cable hit everyone's legs, and they kind of threw their legs up.
So and hers just kept coming down?
Hers, it severed like right above the ankle, and it just took her feet right.
Wow! Imagine you're just on the ride and you're watching your feet fall down. Oh. Like, oh my God, those are my feet.
Your feet do that spin in the air.
Oh God!
And just go plunk on.
You're just
the
watching, going, oh my God, those are my feet.
Wait, on the way up, it severed them.
I don't know,
Danny.
I believe, and I'm not positive, but I think it was while they were still up on the top. I think the tension was such that...
Wow.
So she still has to do the ride down with no feet?
Well, I think it came crash. I mean...
Oh, can we get down? My feet fell off. Could you take... The feet are falling in slow motion like Hans Gruber when he fell out of the Nakatomi Plaza building.
How funny is it that
you're just watching your feet fall?
How funny is it they have more force than the gravity that your body actually makes it down before your feet do?
Oh, imagine that. Yeah, the ride goes, and then you actually are level with your feet.
Watching
looking
fall.
At your feet going, everything going through your mind. I sure hope they could reattach these.
Yeah.
God, look at how I tied my shoes.
The little heels are clicking.
Oh,
so happy going up. They're trying to keep their chins up on the way down.
And who gets the job of picking up the feet off the ground and then throwing them in the trash bag like a sandwich you don't want to eat?
God, is that horrible. You're just riding, and all of a sudden your feet are in front of you.
Let's go to Jeff in Kentucky. Jeff, what's up?
Hey, man, I was in line to ride that ride when that happened yesterday to that girl.
No way.
Did you see the feet? Yeah. Did you see her? What did you see?
Well, the ride went up. Actually, before they got on, this other little girl who initially had gotten into her seat, and I guess the girl that had her feet cut off wanted to ride next to her friend. So the one little girl gets out of her seat, allows this girl to take her seat, and as they're going up, you heard something pop, but you didn't know what it was.
Ooh.
And then you just saw the cable just fly across, and then it because you just seen something fall, and you weren't sure what it was, and it turned out to be her feet, and somebody just yelled down, "Excuse me, sir, can you get my piggies?" And that was really it.
Can you get my piggies?
That's pretty funny.
Oh,
no.
No.
Oh, my, I'm telling you something. How did that not go in?
I think that's pretty funny. Excuse me, sir, could you get my piggies?
My piggies. They fell into the water flume ride.
We're gonna be okay.
What?
I hate this place. We'll be there. Nothing works here. I hate this place. Nothing works here.
Not suspended. You're not on temporary leave. You're fired.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. You're going to be okay.
Victim of the modern age. Will Porter. No, he's dead. Oh, from the corner.
Hey, now, hey, now. Oh, we're taking a mission.
It's over, Johnny.
I'm sorry I did that.
You folks,
I'm embarrassed that I did.
You folks fell on your face. You get an F minus in my book.
I do absolutely nothing around here.
He said, well, you know, we don't have to freeze his whole body. We can freeze his head.
This sucks.
Now we're going to do something extremely fun.
Oh, no!
How are you?
Not well.
Not well. All right, well.
Boy, there's a lot of accidents at those parks that you just don't hear about.
Well, the phones are now
lit. Unless there's legs falling, but a lot of people get a lot of those minor injuries where they got to be sent to the hospital.
Excuse me, sir. Could you get my piggies?
Piggies.
I'm going to laugh at that all day. All right.
I feel bad for crashing them.
Yeah.
It was kind of a good one.
Why don't you take back the crash? Don't you have that?
Yes, somewhere.
We rarely do
there
this.
There it is.
What a polite
okay.
way. We're going to take back the Here crash. The guy actually had a good line.
There you go.
All is right with the world now.
Because you can picture the finger going up in the I hate to bother you pose. excuse me, sir. Could you get my piggies?
My piggies.
And tentatively pointing at one of two severed feet with shoes still on them.
Imagine how embarrassing it would be if they picked up the feet and they had big corn chip toenails on them. Pick out of the way early.
My question is this. As you're sitting there with no feet, and a rider is going, like, he has to go like behind the seats against the mechanism to get your feet, and they're like pulled up in dirty water. There's already an ant on them.
You gotta pick it up and go.
Those ants are creepy how they find blood fast.
They
man.
Don't care what it is. There's a Milky Way wrapper stuck to your piece of your bone sticking out of your shoe.
Did I tell you I was like, when I was on vacation, there was an outdoor area attached to my room, and I'm out there after a nap. And I almost sliced off my fingertip, cutting into a pineapple. And the blood was just dripping all over the patio. I mean, within seconds, ants found that blood. And not only that, there were a line of ants climbing up the wall like a conga line toward the blood. I'm like, how do they know and how do they react so fast to this crap?
Bring
the communication
it back.
System ants have.
Oh, it's yeah.
But it was
little
insane. To, actually, I didn't even wash off the blood because I was so fascinated with these ants just coming from this one direction in a huge line toward the blood that was dripping onto onto the floor there.
Well, a ride like that, the ants probably have, like, they probably nest around there because they go, look, do you see what this ride does? This couldn't be good. They don't. Feet coming off, though, is like the holy grail for ants. They don't expect
they
a foot
love
to
it.
Fly off.
Oh,
that's,
like, no.
That's like a pig roast.
They're probably like a lot of candy has to fall out of pockets, perhaps a booger treat. They don't expect feet to come falling down. They thought it was like a gift from God. They're like, they're still in the sneakers. We can live in these things after we eat them. What do you talk to somebody about as they're sitting on a ride with their feet gone above the ankles?
Yeah, well, ready for the fall?
They're bleeding out under the, like, you just see their shorts and like they're just bleeding to death. What do you talk to them about?
So, where are you from?
Yeah.
Yeah, what are you going to do besides never jog or walk again?
You're going to be able to meet the height requirement to go on any other rides today?
Oh,
need 2 feet to ride this ride.
All right. Hey, it's not going to get any better than that. Let's take a break. All right. Well, we got the update on the feet girl.
Yeah, let's hear about her.
feet girl update.
The girl whose feet were severed while riding on this Six Flags ride in Kentucky is now in stable condition.
In wobbly condition.
In a statement from Vanderbilt University Medical Center, where 13-year-old Caitlin Lassiter is being treated, hospital management said, the parents of Caitlin Lassiter would like to acknowledge everyone across the country that have been supporting their daughter with many positive thoughts and prayers over the last 6 days.
What, did they reattach the feet or not?
They haven't said, and they won't say. They said,
how are you going to reattach the feet?
I don't know.
They gathered them up and took them to the hospital.
Procedure? I don't know.
Some type of microsurgery, I think.
Imagine with a needle and thread, glue and a hot gun.
hot glue gun?
Just gray dead feet.
Oh, they're going to look awful.
Were they put
Franken
them on a little crooked, pointing left? Yeah, they put them... I would have put them on backwards just to be silly.
Don't think you can make money off it.
What'd you say? Also added that Caitlin's parents would like to state for the record that despite claims in the media by representatives from Kentucky Kingdom Theme Park, at no time has any representative of the theme park been in touch with members of the family.
Aww.
That prompted Six Flags Kentucky Kingdom to release this statement. Representatives from Kentucky Kingdom traveled to the hospital immediately following the accident and were there for some time before the family requested that they leave. We are deeply saddened by this incident and, of course, have genuine concern for the well-being of the entire family.
That means the lawyer was like, get him out of here.
Exactly.
Get him out of here. You're going to mess up the case.
Don't screw up the case. We got a good one here.
Oh, yeah.
I'd lose a couple of feet for that type of money.
Would you?
Pounds. Thanks, Ed. Deserve more than a thousand. I was thinking,
very good.
I'm not saying it was a prior bit, but it was short. Just on timing alone.
That wasn't me laughing. It was his feet.
It just wasn't good enough for that setup. That was the problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, dear Bob.
Well, we have this story, and we bought into it, then we didn't buy into it, but now we're getting like audio from a news channel actually reporting this is true.
But I'm not buying it still. I don't know why. It's just too horrific, first of all. And like where it came from is a little odd, but it supposedly came from this news station. WKBW?
That's Buffalo.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's a real news station?
Oh,
you know that?
Absolutely, yeah. Mm. It might be like college news or something, though.
And we have audio of the story as it was presented on the news.
Yes. Correct, sir.
Well, then, okay. Can we you hear it?
Oh, I would. All right.
I'd rather just play it.
You'd rather play it?
Let's play it, and then...
And then we'll talk
about it. We'll see if it's real. Right. Yeah.
Tom B. from Philly, when will you be announcing the winner tomorrow for the TV, the 42-inch plasma? Just updated. Crap. I guess he has something cool. I don't know. It's just updated big time. The instant feedback. Well, we'll give away the TV at the end of tomorrow's show.
Yeah.
The end of the YSP broadcast.
People better come up with some good stuff.
Should be around 9:30, 10 o'clock, somewhere around there if Tom's still listening. All right, here's the story, Ed.
His name is Bear, a young pit bull being held at the Niagara County SPCA after a shocking incident Sunday.
Initial investigation showed that the family pet, a male pit bull, had sodomized a two-year-old boy.
Police say the mother was changing the baby's diaper and briefly left the room.
Heard some screams and returned quickly, found the dog in the act of doing what it was doing, and she screamed. Apparently that must have caused the dog to become afraid.
The dog ran out of the house, and police say that's when neighbors got involved, that they were the ones who actually helped get the dog off of the boy.
See, apparently the dog was connected still
to the,
when he ran
to
out.
The two-year-old?
To the child, as sometimes dogs do get connected during that act. And they had to, like, split them up. You know how you squirt dogs with water when they're hooked up?
What did they squirt the dog with this time? Similac?
Am
I not
going to
make fun of it? A dog fuck somebody? Please. Look, I think the important thing to remember here is that this won't haunt this kid for the rest of his life.
No.
Nobody will ever bring this up in school.
No.
Well, this won't be the argument ender no matter what happens to him in life. You got fucked in the ass by a dog. All right. What end time do you want to leave?
You win.
End of argument. Well, we read the story. We're like, there's no way this is true. But the news channel is reporting
it as news and as true. So I guess...
There's more to the story. Let's
see. Oh, is there?
Yeah. July 1st, I started my 27th year here, and I have never... had an occasion such as this.
SPCA Executive Director Albert Chile has already received a number of phone calls about this case.
I probably had 15, 20 calls this morning. You know, kill those pit bulls. Several people said investigate the family, not the dog.
A DNA sample has been taken from the dog for analysis to verify what happened.
God.
Detective Captain Larry Eggert says they've also turned to an out-of-town animal behaviorist.
And that's kind of what we're looking for from them.
Wait a minute, can you please stop?
Is
this an animal behaviorist?
Me.
What? Yeah.
What are they going to ask an animal behaviorist? What would you say to an animal behaviorist? Why did the dog do this? Because what did he have social aggression?
It's a dog.
He saw
it fucks things.
Yeah,
that's all it does is eat and fuck.
Yeah.
He saw a Heine, he probably, you know, who knows? I mean, that's what it was. I mean, that's what he did. He saw a Heine and he just did it. I mean,
dogs hump your legs and stuff like that, you know. They do that. Whether you want them to or not. And then she's changing the bait. Why would you leave? First of all, I think anybody that has... This was a pit bull?
Yeah.
Anyone that has a pit bull and children are crazy. And I don't care.
They're the most gentle animals you'll ever see.
You don't know
pit
bulls. Shut up. Anybody is an irresponsible parent. Because if they're not fucking them, they're ripping their little faces off. Happens all the time. You just, you can't, if you can't be selfish and have both. Either have your stupid kids or your stupid dog.
Well, they've actually, they have done some further investigating.
Oh, did they?
They checked the dog's computer, and they found a lot of very questionable images. So they feel that this attack was pre-planned.
Oh, that is terrible.
And I had higher hopes for that one.
Yeah, well.
I'm Chris Hansen. Why don't you sit down and have a doggy bone? Enjoying the kibble this afternoon? You might recognize me. I'm Chris Hansen. Now, it seems you had sex with this child. We've checked under your doggy bed and found these magazines and some of these transcripts of conversation. Woof, woof, woof. Woof, woof, woof. You go by the name Woof, Woof, 126.
The conversation went woof, 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 woof. You're 13? Woof, 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 woof.
Woof, woof, woof.
Arr.
Yes, you're free to go. The dog catchers are waiting outside with the nets.
Well, here's the rest of the story.
And that's kind of what we're looking for from them, is some guidance. Tell us why the dog did what it did.
Police say the family has relinquished custody of Bear. Chile says the family apparently wants him euthanized, although he has not received an official request.
Unless there's some sort of an action taken by a third party, the owner of the dog has the right to decide whether the dog is euthanized or not.
The family told investigators that they had never had any problems with the dog before.
No problems with the dog before.
That's what they all say.
It doesn't matter that you're of age in dog years.
Well, we're losing them at this one.
Doesn't matter. They're tired.
Yeah, fuck them.
I'm not going to gauge my performance on those fuckers in that room.
That's right. They probably all think it's hot. They're jerking off.
Oh. Yeah, look at that. Oh,
no,
guys,
well, after that story, it's more like, meowch. Oh.
Well, the one guy was asleep in the front row.
Yeah.
Yeah, you. Yeah, you right there. He was asleep.
Here's the story. By this time of the day,
yeah,
we feel like you do. But it's our job to keep going with this energy and having fun and everything. You guys can just sit there and nod off. Go ahead. There they go.
All right, let's say hi to Mongo the trucker. Mongo.
Morning, boys. I got a punchline for you.
All right.
Why did the old woman cross the road?
Why?
Because she saw a couple of walking towards her.
Wow. It always goes
it
to
It always
there.
Makes that turn. It doesn't matter what we're talking about. So well, that's awful.
So you're buying into that. Well, I guess we have to. I mean, it's a...
Well, if it was on the news, it's got to be true.
It's got to be true,
I have no idea.
An old lady walks into a bar with a horse, and the bartender looks at the horse and says, "Why the long face?" And the horse says, "Ask her. She's got dementia."
Perv News Thursday. We got a great story today about a noseless man accused and kidnapping of a woman.
All right.
You want to get it out of the way? Give the people something good early in the morning?
Could be an advantage to him.
Yeah, exactly.
She's
Or earless. Earless would be great, too.
Earless. The woman. Well, look at the guy. Look at this guy. Look at the picture of the guy.
Oh! Like, wow.
Put that
Scott
picture
Shannon.
On.
What? Dude, what happened? He's got one hole in the middle of his face.
Yeah, and they kind of like, they have some kind of like tube apparatus so he could breathe through it.
Get out of here. There's a tube in there?
Yeah, there's no nose there.
And what's with his mouth?
And the mouth, I don't know.
He's looking like he's doing Bill Murray in Caddyshack. I lost my nose. What is that? What a wreck.
Gonna kidnap a woman.
Kidnap a woman. I lost my nose.
Yeah, what's up with the mouth? You know, Danny?
Is he burning? No, unfortunately, the story doesn't get into how he lost the nose.
All right. It was a gopher accident.
But they make him sound like a Dick Tracy character by referring to him as No Nose and then his last name.
No Nose. It was a sandwich at Augusta. At Augusta.
Looks like he has a T.
My nose is a hole. My nose is a hole.
Looks like there's a T in the middle of his face.
A T.
That's pushed all the way in. Right?
Well, his lips,
you can put a golf ball on there.
Yeah.
His lips are messed up, too. He was a burn victim of some sort.
Something happened. Did his nose get burned off?
I don't know.
Singe his little nose.
But, well, it's Perv News Thursday. Why don't we do this really fast?
Yeah.
It's the, we'll put the picture on Pal Talk for all the folks there, E-Rock. And then somehow we got to get this picture up on our website that no one knows about because we're not allowed to promote.
I know what happened to him, actually.
Huh.
He won the Move Hot Embers with Your Nose competition.
At least he won.
His whole face is just devoid of almost anything. It's like a giant burn area.
Yeah.
A little hole for the mouth and no nose.
And he still, even though he has no nose, you still look at that awful hair of
his. He's sporting the skullet.
The skullet.
Whereas the mullet with the bald head.
All right.
Skullet.
Here's your Perv News for Perv News Thursday.
It's a story stranger than fiction.
They duct taped me here in the house. My ankles, my wrist.
48-year-old Jeanette Reland says 3 weeks ago her live-in boyfriend and two friends duct taped her from head to toe, shoved her inside this car, and drove her from Lake Elsinore to Rosarito Beach, Mexico.
I don't know where that is.
What did you think?
I was going to die.
Reland says she was able to get back across the border with no money and no passport, and when she got home, she reported the crime to authorities. Her boyfriend, Donald Turk, and his two friends, Robert Wayne No-Nose Gardner and Robert Paul McCabe, were all arrested. Reland says No-Nose and McCabe made sure she didn't get away.
They were talking about it on the way down, what they should do to me.
The guy has a real name and they call him
No-Nose.
No-Nose.
They use his real name with the No-Nose in between like a mobster, and then they just went to No-Nose because it's much more funny.
How funny would it be if his last name was No-Nose?
No-Nose.
So boyfriend kidnaps girl.
No-Nose.
With No-Nose accomplice.
No-Nose.
That's what his nightmares are. He wakes up just like thinking he's in a room of Kleenex.
There's nothing he can do about the useless. He just has to curl one up and shove it in and pull it out. That's blowing his nose.
Here's another fun fact coming in. Is this true? I want our research department to look this one up. In 1976, Van Halen is discovered by Gene Simmons. Did we know this?
What?
I think so, yeah.
At the Starwood in Los Angeles, they record a demo at Village Record Studios in L.A., and then two guitar solos are later recorded at Electric Ladyland Studios in New York.
Hmm.
Gene Simmons discovered Van Halen? I had no idea about that. Really? Mm-hmm. Steve, you know that one, huh?
Yeah.
Does he get money from him?
No, he doesn't. He discovered and wanted to be called Daddy Longlegs was the first name he came up with for them.
Really?
Yeah.
What a tool.
That's pretty cool, though. I didn't know that. All right, back to No-Nose.
Yeah.
Strangely, the Lake Elsinore home Turk and Reland share is where we found them both Tuesday night.
You're going to prison. You see my bruises everywhere? See my... Look, they're everywhere.
both were half-dressed, and both smelled of alcohol.
They just walked up to the house and they answered the door?
Well, this is after she got back home. Yeah. And who is she naked with? Her boyfriend that kidnapped her?
Yeah, the kidnapped her.
So he's going to jail even though she's still living with him, and when the news crew came over, they were both half-naked.
They're a little drunk.
Well, and drunk.
According to that news report.
Where was No-Nose during all this? Yeah,
I don't know. That No-Nose wasn't over.
Was he with Prune Face?
And Flat Top.
Flat Top?
He was picking up Mr. Potato Head.
Calling all cars. Be on the lookout for No-Nose.
Yeah, we need some
Dick Tracy
type of music. Yeah, all right.
Both were half-dressed, and both smelled of alcohol.
You told the police that he kidnapped you.
Yeah, he duct taped me.
Yet you're back at the house.
Yeah, because I got to get my stuff out of here. Everything, I got to have everything, all my stuff's here.
Did you kidnap her?
Say yes.
You ever have a domestic dispute? There's nothing serious about it.
So you were kidding around?
We're kidding around. We're having adult fun.
We're having adult fun. Oh. I didn't know Danny was making a comment. We're just having adult fun.
She's just insulted that he brought No-Nose along.
No-Nose.
How dare you insult me with No-Nose? She probably was hoping for a threesome, and the only guy this guy can come up No-Nose. With is No-Nose.
He's good for one thing, the threesome.
Well, Nose doesn't get in the way, you can get right down there.
Yeah.
Here's the good news for her. She doesn't have to shower.
No-Nose, of course.
I have an adult.
Put a crazy straw in there. Drink something.
Investigators say when a neighbor asked Turk about his girlfriend, he said he got rid of her in Mexico and she wouldn't be coming back. Turk, No-Nose Gardner, and McCabe are all facing kidnapping charges tonight.
Yeah, okay. All right.
That's fantastic. No-Nose.
There's your perv news.
There's a little perv news.
Yeah, we'll have some more later on, but No-Nose is a classic. Here, put the picture up on Pal Talk there, E-Rock, or somebody, Danny.
Yeah. Instead of your usual E-Rock, your naked Harry Potter pictures.
Yeah, we'll put No-Nose up there for all the Pal Talkers. Let's say hi to Mike in Pittsburgh. We don't talk to Pittsburgh much these days. I don't know
Mike.
Why. What's up, Mike?
Good morning, guys. How are you?
How are you, Mike?
Pretty good. Can't complain.
People just looking at No-Nose on Pal Talk and just spelling out, ah! Oh, dear God in heaven. Ew.
Ew. Yeah.
Someone just laughing.
Take it down. What a creep.
That is really good.
Yeah.
No-Nose.
No-Nose is a hit today already. What do you got, Mike?
Well, I got a fun fact for you that falls under Perv News Thursday.
Okay.
I'm a firefighter down here in Pittsburgh. We run first responder calls as part of the job. And every year, 400 young men between 18 and 32 unfortunately die of autoerotic asphyxiation.
Yeah.
Yeah, 60% of them, their mother or father walk in on them and have to dress them up before the paramedics get there, so it looks like a suicide.
So how do they find out it's autoerotic asphyxiation?
The hand is frozen in that position.
Its rigor sets in. And
they all kill themselves with a soda in their hand or some sort of beverage.
Well, that's where you get completely naked and hang yourself while you're taking care of yourself. And hopefully you let yourself loose before you die. So you're saying most of the suicides are actually that?
Yes, there's a way of determining it because, unfortunately, when you die that way, you're... You're going out with a rod.
Wow.
Yeah.
And it takes 400 of our youths a year.
Why are you breathing heavy?
Yeah, is this story making you hot?
No, I got a cold.
Are we talking to No-Nose?
Yeah. I think No-Nose is doing me in. I might have to take care of myself here.
Thank you, Mike. Let's go to Joanne in Arizona. Joanne, what's up?
Hey.
Hey.
I have a fun fact.
All right, let's hear it, Joanne.
Arizona is there are more national parks in Arizona than any other state.
Nothing fun about
that. That's not fun. That's just a fact.
That's just a fact, right.
That's not even a fun fact. There's if you love parks and all you want to talk about is parks.
Yeah, there's a difference between a fact and a fun fact. A fun fact makes you go, oh, wow, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, that's not
bad. That's interesting. Oh, I never knew that.
That's fun.
No one is saying that after your fact there, Joanne.
Okay, I have another fun fact that's even better.
All right.
Did you know that you cannot fold a piece of paper more than...
Oh, this one. More than how many times?
Eight.
I can.
Yeah, I've done it many times.
I think they disproved that with a giant sheet of paper.
Yeah.
Not in half.
Yes. Fun fact Thursday sucks.
It doesn't suck. We just got to screen these callers better. Travis, screen the callers. We don't like doing that, but we're going to screen today because we need real fun facts. Not in half. All right, let's try Dennis in Boston.
No Nose has a gaping face.
Yeah,
he's gaping.
Let's listen. This was the story of the day yesterday that we just couldn't play because we had so many guests coming by to say hi. Listen to this one.
Clackamas County Sheriff's deputies are on the trail of another one of Fox 12's most wanted. He's a man caught on camera in a bizarre sexual assault at the Clackamas Target store. Now, we want to warn you that some of the details in this story are disturbing and graphic and not appropriate for everyone.
That is a...
Shut up.
Exactly, shut up.
That makes... If I'm in another room and I hear that disclaimer, I'm running in.
Of course.
To see what this story is about. They should put that in front of every story and you'd listen intently.
Right, and when you hear the story, you have to say to yourself, wow, this is really hot. But you would also have to say, why is the news showing this?
Yeah.
What purpose is the news?
To titillate you.
Exactly, but they don't want to tell you that.
They don't want to say that, so they make it seem like this
they're
is terrible.
They're doing a public service?
Look, let me help you parents out. This is good. This is pretty graphic. It's a little sexy.
Right.
That's what they mean.
All right, listen to this one.
Fake and not appropriate for everyone.
Well, it is a very unusual crime. Deputies say that a woman was shopping in this Target here in Clackamas on Saturday when what happened next shocked her. Take a look at the man the deputies are looking for. He was caught on camera in the store Saturday touching himself and then ejaculating onto the woman. You can see he's...
Holy Jesus Palomino, are you kidding me?
What? Wait a minute, what... How did this happen? Where was it? Was he in a light fixture above her?
Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me?
How?
What?
There's video of it? Is it on YouTube?
Well, you don't think everyone is going to YouTube right now to try to find the video?
How's that video? That's, wow, that's, you know what that is? That's timing.
Yeah.
Because, you know, she's not just going to stand there.
Right. Maybe he's hopping along as he, you know.
You think he's, like, following her or something? And
why? What is the purpose of airing this news story?
Yeah.
I mean, I have no problem with it. I want to hear about this stuff.
Yeah.
But I don't want them to try to, like, make me believe that this is serving a purpose.
That it, yeah,
this should come with a news. This should come with a laugh track.
Yeah. You can just say, you know, a woman was sexually assaulted.
Right.
In a Target.
Right.
And leave it at that. But they had to go into the graphic details.
Mm-hmm.
Next, shocked her. Take a look at the man the deputies are looking for. He was caught on camera in the store Saturday, touching himself and then ejaculating onto the woman. You can see he's carrying a cell phone and what looks like a wallet. The victim spoke with us today but didn't want to appear on camera. She says she was looking at shaving razors when she knew someone was close by and then felt something hit the back of her pants. She quickly realized that...
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? You're just trying to shop. You're just trying to shop.
Do you not notice the irony of this all happening in Target?
Oh, yeah, well,
they show you the bullseye right on the front of the store.
Oh, this guy rules.
Oh, my God, is that funny. Oh, show your face.
She's shopping. She's just like, what, what should I get? What razor should I?
Ah! Ah!
This one's got three blades. This is probably closer shave. With that.
Why wouldn't they show her face, by the way? Why wouldn't? Who cares if she wants to? They don't ever ask people if they want to be on.
No, when they shove a camera in your face and, yeah. Wow.
We show the back of our pants.
Don't just stare at it. Eat it. You like Huey Lewis in the news?
And, of course, the perpetrator had this to say.
Yeah. That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Ah, well, it was Steve C.
Yeah.
Hello.
Anyway, there's more to the story here. Let's see.
Of course,
of her pants. She quickly realized the man had been masturbating in the middle of the store and had ejaculated onto her. She tells us the worst part of the ordeal, which she calls disgusting, is that her three-year-old daughter was there at the time, but she's thankful the girl didn't seem to really see or know what happened. The woman says she's shaken up and doesn't want to go shopping by herself anytime soon, but she does want this man to be taken off the streets. Mm. Sheriff deputies say they're seriously concerned about what they determine is a very repulsive act, and they're testing right now to see if the suspect has any sexually transmitted diseases.
I'm sorry I did that. I'm embarrassed that I did that.
That would be a super disease, going through all those clothes.
Well, yeah, sure, they just want to see if he's... You know, if he does anything else, then...
Yeah.
I made an ass of myself.
Damn! You just been pwned. Oh, were you?
Well, I understand it's unpleasant, but lady, get a hold of yourself. I don't want to go... I'm afraid to go shopping by myself.
Yeah, how often does it happen?
You're the only person in the country this has ever happened to.
Yeah.
Stop. What are the odds? Mm. If it happened to you once, you got it out. It's like a plane crash. You don't have to worry for the rest of your life.
Yeah, you get that one out of the way, right, Jimmy? It's not going to happen again.
Man.
Unbelievable.
That is a...
Good, right?
Yeah, good story.
Pitted, so pitted.
Yeah, pitted, so pitted. Let's say hi to Keith in Jersey. Keith, this is the Opie and Anthony Show. How are you, sir?
Good, how you guys doing?
All right.
I'm a big fan of the show, and I so happen to hear you guys this morning talking about the news article about the woman who had some unpleasants on her in the store.
Yeah.
Wow, look at you knowing how to do radio.
Good man.
Well, there's just so happens to be a couple of different websites that you can get to where in Japanese culture, they do this on a constant basis and put it on the web as comedy.
Really?
Oh, my God. I need this website immediately.
Is that really something that's...
I wouldn't be surprised.
Part of the culture?
There's more than one guy calling saying they do this a lot in Japan.
Yeah, it's big time in Japan. They actually have something also called sharking.
Sharking.
They run up behind women and rip their tops off and just run away.
Danny ran in because he knew exactly what you were talking about. You beat him to it.
You know what
this sharking's all about?
I've seen a bunch of these videos. I mean, the majority of them look fake.
Of course.
Okay.
But, you know.
It's fake.
That's what it is called, and there are plenty of videos. If anybody wants to even bother to look for it, it's...
Talking about working for a living. I'm talking about sharking. Yeah.
Yeah, I figured you guys would take a kick out of that one.
All right, thank you, sir.
No problem. Good night.
All right, let's say hi to Chris in Long Branch. Chris, what's up?
Hey, what's up, man? That guy just said everything I was going to say on the radio.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure he had more to add.
But I got a couple sites for you if you want to put me on hold, and then you can check them out.
Yeah, definitely. Hold on.
All right, cool.
Let's say hi to Adam in New York. Adam.
Hey, I just called to let you know my wife worked in one of those center booths in the mall, and there was a kid sitting on one of the benches right across from her, and he was jerking under the coat.
Whoa.
Yeah, you gotta...
Whoa!
You gotta kind of... Bam! You know. So the guy was sitting across from... She works in one of those kiosks in the middle of the mall, and he was sitting on a bench, and he was taking care of business on the bench by himself.
And now
he'll listen to the radio and get a little edumacation.
Thank you, sir. All right. Let's go to Steve on Long Island. Steve.
Hi.
Hey, Opie Anthony.
What's up, Steve?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
My buddy, he lives out in the Hamptons. He's got out in Quagga, I should say. he's got a housemaid that used to come to his house, and he'd watch her through the bedroom crack of the bedroom door.
Yeah.
And one day she was bending over, cleaning the toilet, and he runs to the bathroom, and he relieves herself on her as she's cleaning the toilet and runs away. And the woman couldn't speak a lick of English, and the parents couldn't figure why she wouldn't come back to the house.
Maybe we can't take any more phone calls on this subject, because we'll try one more, but I don't know. This looks fake.
I don't know, because he has...
What the hell is wrong with these people?
Yeah, just explain what you're seeing.
Well, we're watching, these are videos taken in Japan of guys that are running up behind women wearing little skirts and pulling the skirts up so their underwear is showing, and then they just rip the skirts right off of them. But it does look a little fake, and some of them do.
Nah, I believe these, because what's happening is the women are struggling, the guys are lifting the skirts real quick, just showing, like, the ass. They're panties on, and the women are freaking out, and the guys' faces are blocked out. It's like...
They're just into some weird crap over there, man. What are they doing in Japan?
They just ripped her little skirt off.
God, they love shame. They love shame over there.
What is the whole... I don't get it.
Asian porn has a lot of shame in it. A lot of crying... I noticed that a lot of the videos, like the combination of the videos, the girl like weeping somehow.
Yeah, yeah.
I love that.
Yeah, we're watching just video after video. It's like a montage of girls getting their skirts just completely ripped off of them.
That just makes me feel bad
showing
for
the
girls.
Panties.
Yeah,
look at this lady. She's like, "What are you doing?" Because then they just run away.
They're really violent with it.
Yeah.
Like, because sometimes the skirt doesn't come right off, so they kind of drag them onto the ground. And
you think it's real?
Some of it is probably some
I
of it's
think,
real. Think some of it's real?
Steve, real or fake? What do you
100%
think?
100%
real.
100% real. That means
real.
It's fake. All right, great.
Jeez, that woman was left with pretty much nothing on.
Some you could see are fake, and some are real. Wow.
All right,
that was real. The guy just ran up.
He's lifting the skirt up and pulling the panties down to expose her buttocks.
Yeah, that's pretty great.
Let's go to Michael in Minnesota.
What's wrong with those
they
people?
Are twisted
the weirdest
in Japan.
Stuff they like.
Let's say hi to Michael. What's up, Michael?
Did they say at the end of that story, police determined this was a repulsive crime? Well, did they get together and talk about it? Oh, it was kind of funny. No, you know what? Maybe it's still repulsive.
Yeah, exactly.
I think this was repulsive. Well, let's take a consensus here. Let's get a consensus. Hands raised. Repulsive? Repulsive?
Captain, what do you think?
Well, we've determined that it's repulsive.
Thank you, sir. Let's say hi to Dan in Jersey. Dan, what's up?
Hey, was this unlucky lottery or sucks to be you?
I guess it's a sucks to be you.
Yeah, this is an old bit we've been doing for years, and it's called Sucks to Be You or Unlucky Lottery, which are kind of similar.
Similar, but I consider unlucky lottery something that is so beyond reason happen. The odds of it are just millions to one.
Like the Ray from yesterday.
Which one was that?
Were you here yesterday?
Oh, right, the ray. Yeah. I'm thinking ray like a death ray.
No, the lady
fish,
that was in a boat.
The sea monster.
The sea monster decides to jump out of the water
and
smacks the lady in the face, killing her.
In the face, killing her. That's unlucky lottery.
Because the odds of that are just completely ridiculous.
Millions to one. It's usually a big boulder is on a mountainside. It's been there overlooking the mountains since dinosaurs were walking around. And when your car is driving by it, it decides at that moment to let loose and roll into your car.
Which happened,
and crush you. Yeah, that happened.
That was a real story back in the day. I think that's what started this whole thing.
Yeah, that's unlucky lottery. Sucks to be you is something that isn't that rare. It's rare enough, but it's not rare enough to be unlucky lottery. It's not millions to one, but it just sucks to be you.
You could see it happening again. Like, you can't see a ray jumping out of the water and killing another lady anytime soon.
In the face, right.
Just anytime soon.
60 pounds of fish meat in the face.
But you could certainly see another guy doing what he did to this lady at Target.
Right.
It's not out of the completely out of the ordinary. All right, we got to take another break.
Oh, unlucky lottery. God must have his hand in it somehow. That seems to be one of the definitions. The good Lord must have his hand in it. And hate you, by the way.
Right.
Usually.
The Lord hates your ancestors, yes. and he's making you pay.
God hates you.
Yeah. Let's go to Brady in Queens. Brady.
Yo, it's Grady, but
Grady, what's up?
Grady.
Married man, are you?
But, yeah, gentlemen, this is definitely a hard decision. Lots of fish meat in the face or some on the pants. I don't know which one is worse here.
Well, the fish in the face woman is dead.
Yeah.
So that's probably worse.
Yeah, I would.
Although Steve from Bayshore said old custard pants ought to just shut her mouth.
Yeah, I would. I would deal with what happened in Target. You'd have to choose that one over the two.
Well, yeah.
I wouldn't be too happy about it, but at least you're still living.
So you'd take that over the fish in the face?
Yes, I want to live.
Oh, jeez. Opie. Oh, God.
I want to live.
Oh, jeez. How's the beard?
In either case, guys, it still smells like sex.
Okay. I get his fish reference.
Wah, wah, wah.
Oh, I can do that for you. And you did yourself.
Hey, yeah, right.
Yeah. I'm Audi Hope.
All right, Audi. Thank you, sir.
Peace.
Hey. I want to say hi to all the brother mans out there. I think we could throw another quickie in here before we take a break.
When Richard Long couldn't put two holes in his wall to install his satellite TV system, he turned to his handgun.
Yeah, Richard Long.
Long shot the holes in the wall, but the shots went all the way through to the outside, where his wife was standing in the yard. Patsy Long died from a gunshot.
Wait a minute.
Good.
Oh, he's a genius.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Wait a minute.
Genius.
He's going to get off.
Well, it was an accident.
Ever. All right, honey, you stand here. I'm going to go inside. Right here.
Where's the hammer? Oh, forget
don't
it. Get my
move. All right. There we go. All right. Now I'll finish my job. What was he doing? He was hanging something?
I went back a little bit. Let's listen to this again.
Yeah, where was it? Where they're using firearms as tools?
Then he asked his kids to stand there. Does this look straight?
Yeah. Is this good?
Looks like daddy's free as a bird.
What was he doing, Ope?
We're going to start this one over.
Jeez, I'm out
too
of,
good.
I'm out of bullets, and I got one kid left. Yeah. I was good, digging a pool.
Good time to hang that wall mirror. Somebody call Aunt Lily.
When Richard Long couldn't put Richard two holes Long. In his wall to install his satellite TV system, he turned to his handgun. Long shot the holes in the wall, but the shots went all the way through to the outside, where his wife was standing in the yard. Patsy Long died from a gunshot wound to the chest. It was the second shot her husband fired.
Tragic accident. You know, bad things happen to good people.
Officials what? In Sedalia, Missouri are investigating and say they haven't decided if Long will face charges in the death.
He didn't realize that she was outside, had no clue that she was out there. So,
like,
Hill
that's
says
the point.
This type of case would usually result in manslaughter charges, but that decision is up to the prosecutor's office.
Neighbors also died laughing to the
22, huh?
Jesus.
Wow.
Oh.
So he was probably trying to hang something mm-hmm. on the outside of the wall. Or maybe run wires through or something. Whatever. There's drills for that.
Yeah.
It could use like a drill bit.
Oh, that takes too much time.
Ah, screw it. Get the gun out. You can't kill the wife with a drill.
Unless she's like Lethal Weapon 2 standing up against the outside of the wall.
Oh, yeah, of course.
What was she doing in the yard anyway?
Yeah.
What was that detail? Was she just standing there, really?
Standing right in front of where he's going to be shooting through the wall.
She's like just eyeing it for him. Yeah, that looks about right.
Yeah, eyeball that for me, could you? He's just got a silhouette of her painted on the wall.
Head pops off like Kennedy. Perfect.
First thing he sees on the satellite system is the news with him killing his wife. How ironic.
In HD.
Oh, yeah, in wonderful HD.
Wonderful HD.
Oh, jeez. I wonder what idiot did this. Oh, wait. It's police in my yard.
Chester's Liver from Whackbag writes, it's regular Joe, the captain of the police, saying bad things happen to good people. That's how the cookie crumbles.
Yeah.
Who said she was good people?
I know.
She might have been a real chooch. This guy had every right. You know, she could have been a real a-hole. We might be laughing at the wrong person here. I'm just saying. I'm true. Not saying it's true, but
you never know.
She could have been a real jerk, too.
I don't know. Good people. Huh?
Not that she deserved that. But
he was a good person.
Maybe. They're all stupid, though. I'll say that.
Was he using the gun as an actual tool, or was he pissed like I, when I can't do something, I get pissed?
You just shoot
throw
it?
Throw a bowling ball at the, you know.
Yeah. I have been known to shoot things when I get
have
mad
you?
At them.
Wow.
I've shot my computer.
Oh, was he actually using it as a drill? Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think he was trying to use it as a drill. But at least, you know, I back up my targets. And I shoot in the basement.
I'm a witness. I'm here to say it's as true as he told it.
That goddamn computer was
wow, did
really pissing me off, so I took it downstairs and
pulled an
put
Elvis?
A nice 223 through it.
Really?
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
See, I love him. That's it.
That
true Italian.
Fantastic. Yeah, just pull out the weapons.
All evidence has been removed,
oh,
but
yeah,
I was lucky enough to see it. Randy, Illinois, what's up?
Hey, boys, what's going on?
Hey.
I love your stuff, man.
Thanks.
Want to let you guys know that satellite systems are usually set up on the outside of. What in the hell was this guy doing on the inside of the house, set up a dish? Punching out. Love you guys.
Well, you obviously want to run some wires from the outside to the inside.
Yeah, maybe you wanted to do that. Needed some holes in there.
So
I prefer to use. I prefer to use a larger caliber weapon when running wires through my wall, though. I'd use, you know, 45 or something like that. 22. Jesus.
Cannonball.
All right, we got to take a break.
It's a cannonball. He shot a cannon into his wife's head.
Hi.
Good morning to the little people of America.
Little people.
Hello, little person. How are you today?
They used to be called midgets.
What do you mean, used to?
Midgets.
They're still called midgets in my world.
Believe me, to everybody, they're still called midgets.
Do that, or you just like nod your head to the left and go, ugh.
Ugh.
Hello, little person. How are you today?
Isn't that kind of demeaning?
That kind of sucks, actually, because probably the alarm went off. We're on there. And for that split second, they woke up and forgot that they were a midget. And it's like instantly reminded, oh, that's right. I'm a freak of nature.
Yeah, we wrecked their dream. They were probably playing in the NBA.
Oh, yeah. Or at least just being able to walk down the street with dignity.
Yeah. Spiking the ball over a volleyball net.
You don't need,
and we have to spoil their dream by calling them a little person.
Little person.
Hello, little person. How are you today?
He wakes up smiling and they're like, what'd you dream, that you were a superhero? No, I just dreamt that I was getting my own cereal.
Yeah.
For the it was first great.
I didn't need my little stepping stool to have breakfast.
Words hurt. This is what's so stupid, though. Like, people call them midgets for many, many years. That's a bad thing to do. So now they want to be called little people.
Yeah.
And that's going to be the thing.
The thing.
And then, I don't know, 5 or 6 years are going to go by and they're going to go, hey, we don't want to be called little people
it's
anymore.
Demeaning.
That's demeaning.
It's like, because that to me is like, you're like people, but you're little.
Right.
You're almost like a real person.
Yeah.
If you weren't little.
Just say it. Hello, little person. How is that better than
could you walk up to a midget and say, hi, little person? they'd be all, hey, what are you talking about? Don't call me a little person.
And then they would throw jabs upwards toward your crotch.
Oh, right. They are dangerous as far as those punches are concerned.
Oh, boy, are
it's
they.
It's all just right in the critical area.
They can hit you right in the taint, no problem. So we wake up the little people of America
with those
today.
Vienna sausage fingers curled up into a fist. They can't even make a fist. It's just bent a little bit. And their muffin-like palm of the hand, the little muffin hand.
It's like a little baby hand, isn't it?
It's just like a freaky little wrinkled baby hand.
I think it'd be mad if you just grabbed his hand and went, aw.
Ew.
That's adorable. I don't even know why I'm making fun, because that little people big world brings a tear to my eye every once in a while.
Yeah. Tears of laughter. Just laughing at him, going, thank God that's not me.
We got to get Matt Roloff on the show. I'm telling you, you'll fall for the guy.
Will I?
Yeah, the guy's cool as hell.
All over him.
Guy's cool as hell, man.
Maybe it's dangerous. They're like when Achilles is skateboard around. If you're not looking, you step on him, trip on him.
Yeah, don't get underfoot. You're underfoot. Like a dog heel.
Well, this
Gil midget.
This is a story that that has us a laughing today. A midget, what, scaring a McDonald's worker?
Apparently so.
Oh, listen to this.
Ethan Wade is a customer of McDonald's who also happens to be a little person.
Tonight he's speaking out and calling for change after the way he says a McDonald's employee reacted to his dwarfism.
On March 9th, Ethan Wade went through the McDonald's drive-thru on Howell Road in Greenville County.
Got a fish filet and a double cheeseburger.
He went through the drive-thru?
Yeah, one of those little Jeeps that they put out for kids. That'd be great. Or one of those stupid little kitty bubble cars. You ever see those things they pedal around in?
And he had a double burger. He had a family of six to feed.
He went through a drive.
The drive-thru.
The employee must have thought there it was a car with a ghost driver.
Hey, down here. Hey, hey.
County.
Got a fish filet and a double cheeseburger, and I pulled through the drive-thru and I checked my order, and it was incorrect. So I walked back inside the store to get my order corrected.
Wade says what made things worse was the way an employee reacted to his appearance.
Oh, and when she turned around and spotted me, she threw her hands up in the air, started yelling, "Oh my gosh, oh my gosh," and ran to the back of the restaurant, continuing to yell as she was in the back of the restaurant.
He says another employee was so startled by the response, he thought Wade was there to rob the restaurant.
Why?
Kids kind of react like that, understandable. But grown adults act like that, that's just not acceptable.
Wade says a supervisor said the employee had a phobia of little people and compared it to being scared of snakes and spiders.
They're in the same category as scary little reptiles and bugs.
Yes.
Snakes and spiders. Oh, is that fantastic?
Wasn't that a great story to start the Opie and Anthony show?
So good morning to you little people, midgets, dwarfs, whatever you're called.
We should do phobias today. Actually, that is a real phobia because my brother, I'm serious, the fine owner of F.H. Riley's there in Huntington Village, 400 New York Avenue?
Of course.
He is scared of midgets.
Yeah, some people are scared of midgets. Some have a clown phobias, things like that. It's a little freakish, but a midget phobia, I guess you could get away with that if the person tries to maybe sue you.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hi.
A few of the listeners are bitching that the Homer clip was so loud that they didn't really hear the midget McDonald's story.
Well, that happens occasionally. I do notice sometimes the audio is a little loud over the clip. Sometimes.
We could try it again. It's a quick story.
Yeah, might as well.
All right. Just in case you missed it. This story is making us laugh pretty hard today.
Ethan Wade is a customer of McDonald's who also happens to be a little person.
Tonight he's speaking out and calling for change after the way he says a McDonald's employee reacted to his dwarfism.
On March 9th, Ethan Wade went through the McDonald's drive-thru on Howell Road in Greenville County.
Got a fish filet and a double cheeseburger, and I pulled through the drive-thru and I checked my order, and it was incorrect. So I walked back inside the store to get my order corrected.
Wade says what made things worse was the way an employee reacted to his appearance.
And when she turned around and spotted me, she threw her hands up in the air, started yelling, "Oh my gosh, oh my gosh," and ran to the back of the restaurant, continuing to yell as she was in the back of the restaurant.
He says another employee was so startled by the response, he thought Wade was there to rob the restaurant.
I've seen kids kind of react like that, understandable. But grown adults to act like that, that's just not acceptable.
Wade says a supervisor said the employee had a phobia of little people and compared it to being scared of snakes and spiders.
And midgets.
Right.
That's funny. He's like, you know, he's already accepted the fact that kids are going to joke and make fun of him.
Yeah.
But adults, keep that behind closed doors where it belongs.
The adults laugh the hardest.
Yes.
Maybe not right to your face, but they're certainly laughing. Hey, we got another giant story.
Well, one of big people.
We had a little
call them big people.
We had a little person story earlier. Now we got a big person story. And if you're a faithful listener of this show, we can't get enough of these giants. They hit the news every once in a while.
Stupid pituitary gland.
What sucks though, you have to go to other countries because in this country, you pretty much can't be 8 foot tall anymore.
No?
There's one or two floating around. But
older ones, but they check for all that
but
stuff now.
They figured it out. It has something to do with the pituitary gland.
Pituitary gland.
And they could, like, shut down the juice that is shooting out to make you just a giant.
Yeah, they give them some kind of drugs.
But in other countries where, you know, the healthcare isn't as good, you still get
stupid.
The freaks. You still get the freaks, which I love.
Where they're poor and stupid. Where's this one? From Ukraine? Very nice.
Yeah, somewhere. Somewhere over there. Listen to this guy. Listen closely.
The world's tallest man lives in one of Ukraine's impoverished villages. At 8 feet 5 inches tall, Leonid Stadnik is starting to pick up a few perks, though.
Great success. Just anytime I think of one of these impoverished former Soviet countries, just think of Borat.
Of course.
Great success. The Jew.
Stadnik is starting to pick up a few perks, though. The largest bike in the world, a special engineered exercise machine, and clothes from all over the world.
Why would you exercise?
What good is it?
You like, know, who's going to notice that you trimmed down a little bit? You're 9 foot eight.
And it can't be for health reasons, because those guys don't usually live very long anyway.
No. And he's got the world's largest bike? What does that look like?
I bet that's a treat to...
Wow.
Treat to ride around on. I bet no one looks at that and just goes, oh my God, what a freak.
They're like,
just trying to be a normal guy.
Right.
Just trying to be a normal guy or get a bike. I got my first bike when I was 8 years old. It was 12 feet tall. It was a little big for an 8 year old.
Got truck tires as wheels.
Yes, just
some obnoxious looking thing. Just so you can fit in.
Yeah.
Join this circus and get it over with. Stop trying to fit in.
For Christmas, he got a couple of canoes, and he thought they were shoes, and he put them on.
Walk around with canoe feet on my... I have to put canoes on there because I can't afford shoes that big. They don't make them in my country. Why don't I speak with an accent?
We don't need the accent.
Of course not.
We just love the fact that that's how they talk.
Just their dopey deep voice resonating in his huge freakish body.
It hurts to talk because whatever that's doing to his insides, just to try to communicate.
Leonid Stadnik is starting to pick up a few perks, though. The largest bike in the world, a special engineered exercise machine, and clothes from all over the world. Stadnik says the perks don't make up for the pain. The doorways of his home are too short, forcing him to crouch down when he walks through the house. His 440-pound frame causes constant knee pain, forcing him to occasionally use crutches. And doctors say he's probably still growing. The 37-year-old former veterinarian quit his job after developing frostbite while walking to work. He couldn't afford to buy custom-made shoes for his 17-inch feet, so he walked in socks. Stadnik says the outpouring of international support has kept his spirits up. Media attention brought online friendships from all over the world, and Ukraine's president offered him a supersized car to help him get around better. Stadnik says he now dreams of finding a soulmate.
Oh, good luck.
Keep dreaming. Keep dreaming on that one.
But he loves the WNBA. A 7 foot midget he can get his hands on.
This guy is not only tall, he's really stupid. Why would you walk to work in your socks? You can figure out something else to put on those freakish feet.
Oh, couple of dead cats. Cut open their bellies and wear dead cat shoes. Poor bastard.
Big dope. I wrote him a letter, too. I felt bad for him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What'd you say, Jimmy?
Shoot yourself.
I'm trying to find a soulmate, but I have no soul.
God hates me.
God didn't give me a soul.
God was hungover that day. Just let me keep on growing.
There is no God. There is no God.
Liddy Rules from Whackbag writes, his bike has two of those old-timey bicycle tires. You know, the big
oh,
wheel.
Oh, yes.
The one big wheel and the one little one.
Yeah, who thought of that?
Our ancestors couldn't figure anything out.
How about two wheels the same size, dummies?
Yeah, how long did that take?
I like the fact the French president gave him a new car, but the thing is, it's a special car and it runs on $10,000 a gallon gas. How great would that be? You farm yourself out to the circus, you zilch.
his head sticking out the sunroof.
His whole life should just be a children's party. He's being pointed at. Balloons tied to his face. Balloon on each ear, looking stupid. Be the clown giant man that we like.
Janine writes, maybe they mean soulmate. His dream is a pair of shoes. What are you talking about, soul?
Oh, soul. Yes.
Very nice, Janine. Let's say hi to Chris on Long Island. Chris, what's up?
Good morning, ladies. Listen, the guy can't afford shoes, but he has online friendships. What, he got a cable modem in the house?
Oh, hey, man. Look at that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Looks like someone's got their priorities all messed up. And who would allow him to walk to work in just socks?
Just socks.
He's probably got HBO and pay-per-views and everything else, but watch out.
Thank you, sir. Let's go.
And then you know, like, that the heart can't even pump the blood down to his feet to keep him warm.
Right.
Probably got frostbite in, like, 60-degree weather.
I thought he got frostbite on the top of his head because, like, as he walked, he was going through the clouds.
Oh, right, the high altitude.
Yeah, no.
Boy, that's an exaggeration joke, kids.
We love exaggeration
He'd
jokes.
Have to be really tall for the weather to be different where his head is. See how tall he is? You get it?
Mongo.
Hey, Jimmy, you killed in Minneapolis.
Thank you very much, man. Thank you. Hey, oh, yeah, good meeting you.
Yeah, thank you.
Was it?
Yeah, I actually remember. It's funny, I meet some of the listeners, and I'm like, oh, yeah, you're the guy that that calls in all the time. They don't think I'm going to recognize them, but I normally...
The guy that calls in all the time.
But, I mean, Mongo, I know that name.
Of course you do. Yeah. Why are you shaking your head? No.
Not too many people try to kill E-Rock. This guy was a veterinarian. How many animals do you think he just accidentally snapped their necks?
Yeah, he's just trying to do the right thing, and
oops.
He's breaking animals in half.
With his big, bumbling, huge hands.
And he means well, but
yeah.
There's just a pile of animals in the back that are broken in half.
We're going to need you to take the collar off of this kitten.
Okay. Oh, damn, sorry. There goes another one. Three more and I can make a shoe.
His favorite animal to work on with birds just because they're at eye level with him. He's got a stupid head in a tree working on a bird's nest.
Let's say hi to Sean in North Carolina. Sean.
Morning, boys.
Hey.
Giving this freak a hard time about not having shoes walking to work, but really, two steps and he's there.
That's right.
Right.
More of that exaggerated humor that we love on this radio show. See, he's so tall that his gait would be quite large.
If you want to send him shoes, they should send him, like, regular shoes, just the fronts cut out of him.
With his big dopey toes sticking out of the front.
Like Hulk.
Let's go to Brian in Montana. Brian.
Yeah, they ought to get this guy into porn. He's probably got a cock like a baseball bat.
Well, good morning to you,
Thank
Brian.
Thank you for that.
Good morning. This got the phones lit, though, I'll tell you that much. Charlie, Long Island, what's up?
Hey, Anthony, how much are you cutting the check out for this month?
I'm not going to send this guy any money.
You feel sorry for this guy?
I only feel sorry for Americans.
Oh, really?
That's the only people I'm very charitable
with.
No,
that's not true.
It's not true?
No, you feel sorry for white Americans.
Well, wait a minute.
There's a lot of black charity cases out there.
I know a lot of black people give to black charities.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the United Negro College Fund. Is there another one? I don't know.
Stephen S. from Bayshore. He's still the king of the instant feedbackers.
Yes.
Not to steal from Howard, so that sounded like that. But Stephen S. from Bayshore writes, his specialty was giraffe dentistry.
open wide. Open. Open wide. Okay, spit.
Giraffe dentistry. Just very nice.
He goes to open the giraffe's mouth, and the giraffe just knows there's something wrong with this, and the giraffe kind of recoils like,
Burr. He shouldn't be up there.
Yeah, like, why are you looking me in the eyes? Stupid giraffe gums breath. Ever it smells like leaves. Berries. How punchable are giraffe necks? I've never met a giraffe, but I'm obsessed with strangling one.
Well, where do you strangle?
Yeah, up by the head or down by the body?
I guess wherever your hands can get around.
Yeah. I'd like to clothesline one. That would be funny. Just watch his neck bend like one of those long balloons.
How are giraffes just not attacked? Like, how do every other animal just not go for the throat?
It's all throat.
It's all hooves.
Something happened in nature that they were able to survive all these years.
Because they could get to the leaves up at the top of the trees that the other animals can't get to.
Well, you could get to the neck, like you were saying.
I don't know. Lions don't really take down giraffes. You never see, like, a predator jumping on a giraffe's back.
I bet they're too, like, they probably, their hooves are probably very strong.
Yeah.
And they probably fight, like, they
kick.
They just trample panic. Like, those animals, like, just go, like, all right, trample panic, trample panic. They just kind of jump up and down on you. They just
trample panic, trample panic.
They just fall apart at the seam. Step
love
on
that.
You and...
First, there's
they're
one
just panicky Pete.
I like this.
That's
one,
how they survive.
Zebras do this all the time too. There's one in the crowd that kind of looks up and then turns, and their ears go up, and then runs, and the rest of them treble panic, treble panic.
But they like and the guys like, did you hear any? Did you hear that?
I think there's a lion. Treble panic.
But they step on their opponent like they don't know what to do. So like as the lion's mauling them, they're just like they're just stepping on them with their dumb hooves. I bet giraffes have strong necks too. It's probably hard to get through. It's probably all like
a lot of muscle to hold that head up there that high. I guess
not a big head though.
No,
a
little peanut stupid head with those dumb little antennas.
Yeah,
what the hell those horns on their head are all about?
I don't know, so their hats don't fall off. Nature put in a defense so that their fedoras don't slip off because their hooves can't pick them up. Once you put a hat on a giraffe's head, it either stays there forever because if it falls off, he has no one to put it back.
Fedora.
Giraffes, it's an unknown fact, but they love hats. They're a hat-loving animal. Wouldn't you love to put a fedora on a giraffe?
How funny would that be to some savage just watching this giraffe walk by with a fedora on? Has no idea what's going on.
But you know how cocky he'd be because he had the hat and no one else did?
Hey, look, a picture of a giraffe with a hat.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that, E-Rock?
Just so they could...
Just Google giraffe hat. Of course you did. Wow.
That's so they could root for their favorite baseball team. They want to wear a hat.
Yes.
Hey, let's say hi
those
to
horns.
Sean in Cincinnati. Sean.
Morning, boys.
Good morning.
Welcome back.
Hey, thanks, Sean. We were back yesterday. Most people didn't notice,
though. All he was wanting was a pair of red shoes, bro.
Christmas shoes for the giant, Ro. He got frostbite. I started crying, Ro. Boo hoo.
Christmas boats.
Christmas canoes.
You can do what you want, but don't step on my blue suede canoes. I'd love to meet this giant and bite his big foot.
Bite his big toe.
Oh.
Sink my teeth into it.
Just way back in your molars.
Yeah, just...
And just real hard.
Just gnaw on his big toe. Max, Dallas, what's up?
Hey, what's up, man? I always thought it would be funny to string a piece of wire like they do in the war movies to a guy on a motorcycle on a giraffe and just rip their head off.
Jesus, Max.
Well, you've taken this to a very cool place. Yeah, well, we were talking about giving them hats.
And we were keeping it fun.
But the way Max said, I've always thought about, like, this is a recurring theme for you.
Yeah, always.
Every time he drives by a Toys R Us, he just thinks that Jeffrey the giraffe being decapitated and how hilarious it would be.
The piano wire.
Gotta pull over and have a laugh to Johnny Ola. He goes to Johnny Ola, Jeffrey the giraffe. Yeah, Jeffrey the giraffe showed me. You broke my heart, Fredo.
Let's say hi to Matt in Georgia. Matt.
Hi.
Matt, you're 7'4"?
Yes, sir. You know, the funny thing is, you know, my wife's only 5'5", so, you know, whenever we go to the mall or something, I get mad at her. I just gotta walk away. She's gotta run behind me and shit. Looks funny as hell.
Whoa, let's not curse too much.
Yeah,
there.
You tall people like to curse.
I'm sorry.
So, did you play hoops or what? I'm sure you're asked that all the time.
I actually got kicked out of the YMCA for being too rough. So I didn't really play all that much basketball. I was really big in football, though.
Football.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. 7'4"?
Yeah,
pretty.
Yeah, I hit my...
Are you gangly? Are you gangly or muscular?
I'm actually a little portly, to be perfectly honest with you.
How much do you weigh? Wow.
350 pounds.
He's got a shop at that store that has like one pair of pants for him, one shirt.
Anyone else?
Just like Fred Flintstone, it's the same thing every day.
Anyone else notice that this phone call is going nowhere?
Well,
like,
nowhere
like this guy's been waiting years to be able to participate in the Opie and Anthony show, and here's his big moment.
Nowhere.
Hey, they got a story about a tall guy, and I'm tall. I better call in.
I'm going to call in and tell him.
I got a great story for you.
All right,
okay.
Let's go.
Okay. Last year, I was playing laser tag, right? And we're running around in the place.
Must have looked stupid.
No shit. I actually ran.
Hey, what did we say about the cursing there?
Damn it.
So you were doing some of that laser
tag. Laser tag.
Yeah, I actually ran around the corner and beamed my head on a sprinkler. A water sprinkler, you know, the ones that hang from the ceiling.
We assumed that, yes.
I cracked my head open on a sprinkler hanging from the ceiling. No one should have ever
seen. We heard that.
Yeah, we heard that.
Heard that story already.
Let me ask you this, sir. What's the worst part about being the height you are?
Everybody constantly asking, how tall are you? I probably get asked that probably 40 times a day. It's really annoying.
40.
All right, well, that's not that bad.
I know how tall I am. They know I'm taller than them, but yet they continue to ask.
All right, so how about, let me ask you a question. Not the most annoying part. What's the worst part? Like you know, using public bathrooms. I'm not talking about the irritating questions.
I can't drive anything other than a big truck because I'm huge and won't fit in a car. You should see me try to get in a Honda. Well, I got size 19 shoes, so I had to special order everything out of a catalog.
And how big is your, thing?
What do you pack them?
What do you pack them?
Just give us a number.
It's probably, nine inches.
Yeah, that's good on anyone else.
Nine?
But on you, it's a minuscule embarrassment.
Yeah, I mean, if you're a 7'4", you got to be hoping for more than that.
Yeah, it just looks silly.
All right, Matt, thank you. We're going to move on because Sean's got something good here. Sean in Jersey, what's up?
Not much, guys. Hey, I was thinking about how he had those online relationships.
Yeah.
What, has he got a huge keyboard? Is he typing with those big, 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 stupid fingers in it?
Big mitts. Yeah, he has a custom keyboard that's just giant.
Yeah, each letter is the size of a fist. just so he can type. Yeah, if he uses a regular keyboard, man, how is anyone going to decipher what he's trying to say?
Yeah.
Oh, look, I got an email from Fluff.
right.
Big dumb Lummox.
Right.
Goes to say hi. It's just an H, a J, and an X, and a Q, and send by accident. Big dope.
Big angry typing guy at a new level.
Right. Yeah.
Okay, guys, punch it out.
Very nice. I think we've come to the end of the line
on that story.
Of the giant story.
Yeah. And scene.
And, yeah, exactly.
Oh. It was very rude.
Yeah. That's what shock jocks do. They burp on the air and people
it's
go,
shock.
Wow, that's outrageous.
Shock talk.
Opie and Anthony. All right, we got a little story. We're going to start doing radio now.
Let's try this on for size.
Yes.
South Australian police are monitoring a father and daughter revealed they are a couple and have a child together.
Ew.
John and
Sexy.
Jenny Deeves were reunited 30 years after Mr. Deeves separated from Jenny's mother. They told 60 Minutes they fell in love and now have a daughter together. The couple said they knew it was wrong, but emotions took over.
So John and I are in this relationship as consenting adults, that we are not harming each other.
Poor males.
Along with 9-month-old Celeste, Jenny has two other children aged 9 and 14 from previous relationships.
She's a slut.
Not from a previous relationship.
She said from previous relationships.
You dirty cow.
And now she's fucking her dad.
Fucking dirty cow.
She's fucking her own dad. That's disgusting. Their daughter has two heads and four arms.
When you recognize your own smell, like...
Ugh.
Oh.
I don't know. I don't know if your daughter has the same smell.
Probably deep down there's a similar smell.
You mean deep down?
That's when you're in bed having sex with your daughter.
Smells
you don't
like
know
a
at the point.
Fucking wallaby pouch. You're filthy. Ugh.
That's fucked up, huh?
But the doctor was alluding to that. Remember, he kept saying people are going to come back and fuck themselves.
Yeah, there's the Dr. Cocker.
Yes.
There it is.
The finger's up.
We got a great story that hit today. Listen to this.
T-shirts for fashion or opinion to make a statement. But is this one too much? It says, I was raped. The Seattle woman selling these shirts online is a rape survivor. She didn't want us to show her face, but says she will wear the shirt.
And to even have had that language, to know what to call it, or to know that it had happened to somebody else, would have made a tremendous difference for me in terms of not feeling like it was something I should be ashamed of.
You have to think about the consequences and what would be, I mean, it's not likely to happen that you're going to have everyone who's been raped wearing a t-shirt saying I've been raped.
This lady's insane. Just trying to get controversial.
First of all, I want that shirt. And second of all, I'm not a rapist, but if I was, I would seek those shirts out.
No kidding.
Like, well, it's like getting struck by lightning twice, huh, honey? Yeah.
What it's doing is pointing out the easy targets. It's
fucking unbelievable.
Not only did I get raped, I obviously didn't mind getting raped.
It's funny when the back says cock tease.
Oh, shit.
Wow. Or it would be even funny if it said braggart. No, it wouldn't.
Lucy Berliner, director of the Harborview Center for Sexual Assault, hesitates to say victims should wear their pain on their sleeve.
What is this person looking for? Are they trying to get a reaction? Are they trying to get, see what I think?
Why use such a strong message like this?
Because, you know, we think that there are a lot of women who need it. I mean, it's certainly not for everybody. Everybody's kind of healing process is a little bit different.
You don't think it could backfire?
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, I think absolutely that you can wear some...
What is she talking to, Roseanne?
That's fucking unbelievable. It sounds so phony. And I want to know where I'm starting a line. I'm a rapist. I'm going to start those fucking t-shirts
up. I think absolutely that you can wear something like this and probably be met with scorn or embarrassment.
That's what Berliner fears. Parents shot down Bon Macy's Boys Are Stupid shirts. The Mariners banned Yankees Sucks shirts. But experts say the damage when these shirts don't get the right reaction could be lifelong and devastating.
God. Yeah.
I would love to see someone in that shirt. So how was it?
Oh,
what? You know. My eyes are up here. Yeah, but your rape sign is right there on your tits. Might I say it's lovely.
Well, PC from Virginia writes, I was raped on the front, and on the back it says, by a...
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Person.
So we have this old broad. I don't know. I guess I'm an asshole, because to me it's like, ugh. These
You're
things
right,
are,
fuck
ugh.
Her.
Yeah, and the news picks up on
they
these.
They love stories like
this. There's one in your Human town, interest. I'm sure. Like... There's a list of things every local news checks off. Like, oh, this time of year, we got to find a real old person that's graduating either high school or college.
Yeah.
We should do that list. That would be a good little quick bit.
Yeah,
The list that local news checks off. The feel-good story. The, you know, send the black guy to the black crime scene. All that crap.
Yeah.
We could do a whole hour on that, matter of
oh,
fact.
Oh, hell yeah.
But anyway, this time of year, all the local news stations need to find the old broad graduating high school, and it's a feel-good story for everybody. I hate these because they just seem forced.
It's that human interest thing.
So here's the latest one.
Today was a very special day.
Most seniors wait 4 years for the cap and gown, but for Ann Cola Giovanni...
And they report it the same way and everything. Most, yeah, we know most.
Yeah.
But in her case, she waited 80.
Ann Cola Giovanni's one victory is that she's made it to 97. Her walking down the thing with that dumb hat and gown is not the accomplishment. It's the fact that she's not dead.
At 97.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
She's not dead.
Today was a very special day.
Most seniors wait 4 years for the cap and gown, but for Ann Cola Giovanni, it took a bit longer.
Just incredible. The people that came, it just really touched my heart.
Ann, or Anna Lupica as she was known in the 30s, was only 17 years old when she quit high school to work at her father's meat market.
It was the depression years.
Oh, she was a hooker. He ran a brothel lane.
Getting your education.
Ann ended up working at the store for decades. She married and had two daughters. But even at 97, there's something she's always wanted.
You're going to have your diploma. No, Mom.
Black now her alma mater, Sugar.
Were you there, Jimmy?
It was, except I thought black dick. It's amazing how cock. We are
I'm sure
just, but to be on the same page with somebody and the answer is black dick.
that's a problem.
Fucking total idiot.
Yeah.
She's always wanted.
You're going to have your diploma now, Mom.
Now her alma mater, Sugar Heights High School, is giving her that dream.
And it's my great honor to present this diploma to you. And you'll see it's June of 1934, That's when we believe that would be the appropriate date.
Oh, my name is him.
What the fuck was that?
That's why I know we're fucked up, because most people would see that and probably get a tear in their eye.
Oh, that's sweet.
To me, that's just hilarious.
I gotta hear that old fucking cackling broad. Oh,
1934. But I don't think she should be rewarded for being a dummy. It's obviously taken her all these years to complete her courses.
Why are so many Negroes in the school? We're using our fountain. They look like they're stealing things. Homosexuals. Okay.
Sounds like they put the diploma up her ass.
I've gone to the bathroom on myself. Help me.
Want to hear that again?
Let's hear it again.
I got to make sure I go.
Love it.
1934. That's when we believe that would be the appropriate date.
Oh, my name is him.
What did she say?
Oh, my goodness.
It's like Roland. What did she say?
I think we're listening to
my God.
Oh, my. It did sound like, oh, my God. It was like, oh, my.
I think the N-word's in there somewhere.
Yeah, probably.
I think so.
Or that's when we believe that would be the appropriate date.
Oh, my name is here.
Oh, my name is there. Wow, Battleship. That's pretty fucking good.
Oh, my name is there?
Oh, my name is there. She must have pointed at the diploma like...
Yeah,
oh,
she's looking at the diploma.
My name.
Can we see the video?
If you want.
Oh, yeah, I want to see the video.
People know how to translate old bag.
Yeah. He speaks old bag.
Don't worry, she speaks more.
I'm fluent in battle axe.
No. I just want to... Travis ran blocker and I just colored all over Sam's notes.
He's got his notes. How that's not the first time this has happened to you.
Somebody translates old bad.
College person. Using the bathroom that we...
You know what? She's an inspiration. You work really hard and that's what you get. You get what's good.
Shut it, Chippa-Dee.
What? The old lady should be very happy for the elderly person.
Yeah, we should be. And Cola Giovanni.
Everything on that CD
Hey, turn this married bitch.
It's on there?
Oh, shit.
So fucking start over so we can see this old bag.
Anna Lupica,
oh, she's in a wheelchair.
She was only 17 years old when she quit high school to work at her father's meat market.
It was she was kind of hot.
She was a goer.
Go back. Let me see that.
Yeah.
Go back. Fuck. Pause it and go full screen, you motherfucker.
Come on, you queer.
It was the depression years.
Pause it. Pause it when she was fucking.
I don't want to see the meat market store.
Yeah, look at that place.
Oh, look, they're selling spam.
They're selling black people. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Fucking. You know the bush that was on her.
Fuck it, like her head.
Oh, exactly.
Wait, what year was The Wizard of Oz?
39.
She fucking graduated high school 5 years later. The Wizard of Oz came out.
She never graduated.
Oh, but I mean that time.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Oh man. Yeah.
Imagine trying to finger a chick to that movie in the theater.
Oh, how great was that?
They probably did. The Wizard.
Big fucking hair. You just have fucking. Big fist of hair.
Yeah, it's like...
Ugh!
Yeah, it's like dipping your fucking hand. It's like eating pudding out of a shrub. Rotten old pussy.
Hey, she got a lazy eye in that photo from 1934.
Can't really tell. It's a little blurry.
That left eye looks
she's
a little low.
17. I like that little vest number thing she's wearing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's pretty good. Just take that off.
It's hiding the boobies.
Fucking tits.
It's hiding the boobies.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Come on,
let's
Sam,
see the rest
stop
of
fucking
this.
Around, yeah, texting your wife and stuff.
The Depression years, working was more important than getting your education.
Anne ended up working at the store for decades. She married and had two daughters. But even at 97, something she's always wanted.
Oh, she's got a walker. She's in a cap and gown with a walker.
Oh, my God.
Time stinks! Time stinks!
She's not bad looking for 97.
Oh,
she's
97.
I gotta say. She's not bad for 97.
It's like an old apple.
Oh, there's a little...
It's like a rotting apple. Fucking face.
You're mean.
I am. Fuck her. Fuck her and her dry pussy. Hate this woman.
Did she allow that?
Oh, okay. No.
Is that the year she was born or the year she's graduating?
I was thinking the same thing.
She's got a tassel with 12 on it.
12 on there.
You don't like her?
No. Hate this shit. Old people disgust me.
By old, anybody over 18.
Transparent skin.
Fuck, like a dried apple.
I just hate how predictable this shit is with the news.
I know.
Good for her, I guess. What else is she supposed to do?
She throw her fucking cap in the air at graduation and break her hip doing it.
It fell on her foot and smashed it. All right.
Old pretzel rod legs.
Giving her that dream.
Oh. And it's my great honor...
Jesus, our hands look better than mine.
To present this diploma to you.
Fuck.
And you'll see it's a June of 1934. Oh. That's when we believe that would be the appropriate date.
Oh, my name is him.
Pause.
Shut up.
Oh, my name is
No, miss. That's over here. That's his burden. This is... Oh, she's doing that because she's reading the obituaries.
It's the weekend's obituaries.
He should have shown her the diploma taped to a pillow. Get a closer look.
Here you go, Edna. The last thing she smells is ink.
It smells like they just ruined it.
And then she's dead.
Oh, there's the middle of her name imprinted on her nose. Like silly putty. Old silly putty face picking up the newspaper print.
I want fucking two orderlies that look like fucking defensive linemen from the Rams.
Yaphet Kotto.
two fucking orderlies.
Shit. Someone's going after Anthony. Corey in North Carolina. Go ahead, Corey.
It sounds like Anthony has a little sign of jealousy in his voice, maybe because he doesn't have a high school diploma.
I never graduated. I failed gym class so they wouldn't graduate me, even though I was smarter than everyone in school.
Fuck school! Drop out, kids! Drop out! It does nothing! Look at me! I'm a success story! I don't even have a GED!
This would be a good bit. Anthony goes back to school.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
We've
talked about it for a year.
Right. Get my curls.
Call me when you have no class.
Hey, all right.
we even tried to get a hold of that guy.
Yeah.
That went past your gym.
I know. Fucking Coach Cirillo.
Pete Polino
was that.
Gotcha.
But they're all either dead now or they have like Alzheimer's and shit. So I could probably get the diploma pretty easy. Hey, remember me, valedictorian? Mm-hmm. Could you fucking give me a diploma?
Okay. this broad's father was a dick, by the way. Made her drop out as a senior.
Back then, it was a different time.
Oh, it was a different time.
Didn't need college, Gregory. Back then, it was so much of a different time. As
the depression.
Anthony just said.
You had to work to support the family at the meat store.
My first husband threw himself out the window. We lost everything
in the big crash.
Yes, in the big crash. He bet on the stock market. Apparently, someone doesn't have improv skills because I'm only saying he bet the stock market. With nothing funny that he bet on that obviously would have failed. That would have been the joke.
Like something you could have mentioned like Union Carbide as a stock and the fact that he had shares in Union Carbide and it crashed. Not funny, but...
No, but very truthful. But I was going for the joke. Like I could have said he was investing in multiracial water fountains or something, which weren't to be for quite a while.
Not a very popular item.
Yeah, water for everyone signs, and he didn't sell any.
Water for everyone.
Yes, all lips meet here.
Who does that look like right there?
Who does that look like?
Yes.
The Crypt Keeper.
It looks like the woman that got her hat knocked off in the elevator.
Oh, God.
Got the same color hair.
I think it looks like Don Imus.
Oh, my God. Look, my name's on it. My name's on it.
Doesn't that look like Imus?
Don Imus. Imus in the
shocking
morning.
Shocking white hair?
Yes.
Holy
oh, my God.
Fuck, it's creepy.
Imus in the morning, graduating high school.
He's not going to be happy that way. You think he looks like a 97-year-old woman.
Oh. How do you think she's going to feel?
Yeah.
You look like Imus.
I like her poker chip earrings.
What's
the
that?
Fuck is that? No. Oh, damn it. I hate when I do that.
Is that her earrings or her ear lobes at this point?
I know. Old ladies with their fucking earrings and it weighs down like gravity for 90 years has just taken its toll.
Her nose held up. Usually the noses get bigger.
I tell you, one good... Look at the little fruit bowl behind her with shitty plates.
That's awful.
What do you think the clit of a 97-year-old woman looks like?
Oh, God.
What do you think it looks like? Can we get a picture of that somewhere?
What, 97-year-old clit?
Just Google old clits or something.
Old lady clit.
Old lady clit. See what comes up.
I bet it's horrible.
Oh, you're tickling my clit.
Because we know the ears get weird and the nose gets weird and the skin in general gets weird. There you go. Is there an actual picture?
No. Stop it. What is that? What is it?
Lick that. It looks like a monster's ear.
I can't put it together. Is it this way?
It's up. It's there's the way it's supposed to be.
No, there's sores
there's
on that.
There's sores on that.
That's something
Sam.
Bad. Sam.
That's not. No,
there's sores on that.
Google old lady pussy.
That's crazy.
Oh, my. Yeah.
I don't know what that is.
That's
that looks
asshole.
Like a. Butterfly, a rare butterfly fillet.
No, the first one was good. That's not sores. That's just what
it
happens.
Looked like sores.
Oh, what's the first picture? That like old broad naked posing. Oh. Go back again, Sam, please. First picture that comes up.
Oh, Sam.
Oh, it's just a drawing.
That's painting.
I'm sorry.
Oh, oops. There we go. That's horrible.
Old lady clit. Well, let's play the rest of this.
Let's see the rest of the news story.
It's your feel good story.
Yeah. Here she goes.
If it's a piece of heaven, something her dad had only hoped she'd achieve.
I'd be so happy to know that finally I'm going to be. I'm going to be.
A graduate.
Dead. A graduate. Yeah.
And to top it off, she isn't the only one celebrating. Her grandson Thomas is also graduating from Shaker Heights.
Oh, great.
Just one day later.
Oh, she looks so cute in that thing. I don't even know really what to think.
Gay!
She's gonna wear her cap and gown tomorrow.
A dream 78 years in the making, one she'll never forget.
Shaker Heights.
For the next 2 weeks.
Exactly. She'll be dressed in that on the silk pillow.
And that Lawless.
She'll forget
Fox
by sundown.
News.
Yeah. Aww. What a feel-good story that
that's
is.
Sweet, isn't that though? Nice?
Home, you old bat.
It's good. I'm getting it. The media, though, every year. And they make believe they didn't do this story last year. That drives me nuts,
I know.
Too.
She couldn't say the word graduate. She was too sad.
Connect her liver spots. The pen.
You know, I'm watching Little Einstein with my kid. And you know that retard really means slow in classical music?
Yeah, right.
Retardo? Mm-hmm.
Retardo.
So why can't we say retarded anymore?
Yeah. Yeah, you could say retardo when you're talking about Roland.
It's retardo, but then retardissimo, I think. And
retardissimo. Ah.
So why don't they go after the classical music people?
I don't know. I guess they
started
that
shit.
Thing. Yeah. Retard is always retard. To retard something.
It's a little bit slow.
It's always meant to slow it down. Pull it back a little bit. Retard it. Dude. You know, you retard the spark on your fucking, in your car when you twist that distributor.
They had a Waterhead story on CBS this morning that fucking brought tears to my eyes.
Really?
Yeah, maybe I shouldn't, like, present that
in
the way I just did, but a kid has got the down.
Oh, got the down syndrome.
He owns his own fucking restaurant.
What?
For real. Not, really? Like, fake owns.
He really owns it.
And his parents leave him every fucking day, and he's in complete control.
Oh, man.
And he seems like he's not in the shallow end of the Down syndrome pool.
There are very...
He's sort of in the middle.
Amazing
He's not in the
levels.
Deep end, but he's kind of like, not just a little taste of it. He's got it.
There
he's
are
got it pretty good.
Profoundly retarded people.
And supposedly his restaurant's doing real well. I think it is Tim's Place restaurant.
Tim's Place.
Takes unique approach thanks to special owner. And they're going to franchise.
Come on now. Are you going to have Down syndrome in order to
and on the
get
menu,
a franchise?
And on the menu, you could order the Tim Hug.
What?
And I was,
no way.
I was bawling like
no way.
And I was bawling like an asshole.
Oh,
I was
my
bawling.
God.
I can admit it.
No way.
I was bawling.
Literally a hug from him?
They did this for Father's Day, of course. So they really fucking, you know, play your heartstrings.
What a difference 26 years makes.
Out here.
Today, here in sunny Albuquerque, you'd be hard-pressed to find a more glowing father than Keith Harris.
Appreciate you coming out and walking with me.
Or a more shining example of what truly great parenting can accomplish.
Oh.
Keith and his wife Jeannie, who also have three
That's
typical
nice,
boys, have raised them all
the
same high expectations.
Oh, they zoomed out of the picture.
But none more
I gotta explain what happened.
Oh, gee.
They showed a family photo. And And yes. They slowly zoomed out from the parents and showing one kid at a time.
It looked like the perfect family.
That's so wrong, man.
There it is. Look at those two boys.
There's three boys.
I mean, they're adorable.
Right.
And then you pull out a little.
Still pulling out, pulling out, pulling out.
No.
See, we can't do this. It brought tears to my eyes.
Oh, did it?
I can't play both parts today.
Aw. Well, I want to hear what he did. This is a nice story.
As a result, they're all successful, but none more successful than Tim, who not only lives on his own.
He worked for me.
He owns his own restaurant.
Hey guys, welcome to my place.
In fact, as far as we know, Tim is the only person with Down syndrome in the country who owns a restaurant.
The rating in the window is R.
All of us who are dads want our kids to wind up having a life where they are independent, happy, secure.
Morning.
That's why Tim's dad, a small business owner himself, provided the initial investment.
I bet.
Other people do the managing.
Yeah, come up with the capital.
But Tim is the front man.
Here we are.
And the genius behind it.
You're welcome.
Tim figured out what people really want from a family restaurant is a family feel. That's why here, love isn't just in the air. It's on the menu.
Aww.
You can actually order a free hug from Tim.
Calorie free.
Don't order it.
Oh, it's on the menu. One.
Calorie free.
His measure of
he just hugs everybody.
Almost 19,000 hugs. Almost.
Will you keep track?
Yeah, in the hug counter.
The hug counter.
I have a hug counter.
Of course.
All right, he's pretty functional, this guy. Come
Tim
on.
Even has
Let's be real.
Plans.
Give me a hug.
And yet, no matter how big he gets, Tim says he will always be in debt.
I bet he's all crazy about that hug counter. I bet he's fucking crazy. Yeah, hold on a second.
You think he's obsessed with that?
I bet he's fucking obsessed with that goddamn hug counter.
I do hear they focus on one thing.
Like the second someone at the door is like, give me a hug, and he gives a hug. Put it up on the counter! Hug counter! Another hug in! Everyone's trying to run the restaurant, and that's all he concentrates on.
You don't give a fuck that sales are way down because he's just pushing free hugs.
Yeah, you think he just created the restaurant just to give hugs?
Yeah.
And count them?
Do you think he's in the office with a fucking visor on going over the fucking books? No. He's got his own book. Like somebody, an accountant is sitting there deciding how much has to be spent on food and overhead and employees and what's coming in every month. And he's there going, had five hugs.
He's got one of those old time calculator.
Yeah. No 10 hugs. Right.
Business guys. Is in deep trouble. And then try to explain to him, look, we could save this. We just got to get rid of the hug counter, please.
Yeah, the hug counter really
God,
is.
It's not doing anything for us.
Concentrate more on the business end of this. Hugs, very important. Very important hug.
But the story made me cry. You'll see. You'll see the
more.
Part.
All right.
Inspiration.
I'll go back. See, you missed it.
Yeah, that was that looked a little.
Almost.
Will you keep track?
Yeah, in the hug counter. On the hug counter.
Of course, profits are adding up too. Tim even has expansion plans.
Give me a hug.
And yet, no matter how big he gets, Tim says he will always be indebted to that man who gave him his first hug.
Oh boy.
He's my superhero and my inspiration.
Oh, he's crying. So
happy for you.
Oh yeah, thank you, Dad.
I don't think any one of us can imagine the time and tears that went into this moment right here.
I'll see you soon.
That made it possible for Keith and Jeannie to walk away from their son and know that he will be all right with or without them.
Is the reporter crying?
Only Tim knows that, which is why this Father's Day, no father in America will be any more appreciated than his.
I love my dad so much.
Steve Hartman.
I wish I could say that to my dad.
New Mexico.
I never got to say that one last time to my dad. What are you doing?
I was trying to think of something. Wait a minute.
What are you doing?
I came out of Dayton, Ohio with two bad brain lobes and a dream to own a restaurant.
Wow. It's a nice thing I brought to the show.
It's very
it's a
sweet.
Nice thing.
Of course it is.
Nice thing. Father's Day just passed.
Hug counter!
You think he's just constantly asking?
He talks about it all the fucking time. After work, during work.
You think he has a hug counter t-shirt that he sells?
Oh, God. Look how many hugs. Everyone that comes in. Another hug up on the board.
No one wants to hug them. No,
they're just like, they come on. They have to. Hug's on the menu. You got to.
They have to because they have a tasty, what was it,
Monte Cristo?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Can I have the Monte Cristo? Let me tell you about our specials today. Free hug.
Free hug.
Oh, yeah.
Before we get started, free hug.
You want the hug? He asks. It's all awkward. Now you got to say yes.
Mm.
Oh, man. Oh, I'd love to go in there and just smash that hug counter with a hammer.
you just hate everything nice.
I do. I'm terrible.
Oh, God.
Now, that's a very sweet story. That is. The guy's highly functional. I don't know if that's the correct thing to say. You know.
Yeah, man.
But
yeah, he is.
You know. Watch the opening sequence of From Dusk Till Dawn and get that sheriff's take on the whole thing. It's hilarious. Yeah, I'm going to fucking have a potato head making my food for me. I don't think I should be doing that. That's fucking hilarious, that scene.
Mm-hmm.
And he gets his brains blown out.
Another movie I got to see. It's been a while.
It's fantastic.